Peace to the believers. It's the wonderful counselor, Yah Nabi, Yah Rasul. Come on in and holler at your people, man. There she is, Mrs. Muhammad. Peace unto you. Good to have you on. Mwah. Let's make it last. Our God is only one God, and He wants to be with us forever. Come on with it. And don't let our loving let me hear you tell me you love me. Let me hear you say you never leave me. Ooh, girl, that would make me feel so right. Let me hear you tell me you want me. Let me hear you say you never leave me, baby, until the morning light. Salute, Yahudi Yah Salvation. Good to have you on. Yah Elder Israel, peace unto you. Salute. No one but you, baby. Listen to the lyrics. Only God can do this. The way you make me, feel. Whoa, whoa. Don't let our love in. Y'all humble. Salute. Says praise Yah Almighty forever. Forever. Your touch. Ariel, good to have you on. Praise Yah Almighty. Yes, oh marvelous. You are so fine, says Mrs. Muhammad. Yes, that's how I pulled you. Now, that knowledge drive you in. But it's good that you delight in the looks. Praise Yah Almighty. No one could compare to what we have. Yeah, it feels so good, and I'm so glad you're mine. Oh, oh, oh. Teaching purposes, YouTube, do not take it down when it's uploaded. It's only for educational purposes. I do not own the rights to this music. Yes, there is a playlist on my YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't. You will see the Yahweh Music playlist. It's over 200 songs, possibly over 300. And count it. Because our God is a forever God. He speaks to us not through just books, also in music. Praise Yah Almighty forever. Oh. Make it last forever and ever. So relationships aren't supposed to be short term. Relationships, marriages are supposed to be forever. And our God created us. And that's where our beginning came from. And our ending will also be with Him. If you have one. There will be some. But many will live forever. After the first judgment. After the first death. And you're going to be either in hell or you're going to be in paradise. That is why it is very vital to do good things while you're here in this life. store up your treasures for the hereafter, because the hereafter is longer, more lasting, it's forever. This right here, we all got a period of time, and then we all will come to expire here. Okay, so, and this is the test for you. How are you going to act? How are you going to respond? How are you going to consider your God? Are you going to think that you can do without him? Are you going to depend on the creator of all things, or you call yourself self-made? You have to be real careful about these things, these sayings, and a lot of things that's picked up from the celebrities, the actors, the rappers. And some of the rappers are woke. Some of them are woke. So, you know, just be mindful of what you're putting into yourself. And it'll be better to put in mindful things like the Quran, the Dhammapada, the Book of Psalms, the Book of Proverbs, the Book of Sirach, while listening to the Yah playlist. All right? This will change your life. This will give you a better mind frame and outcome. And if you guys are not reading the reminder, if you guys are not reading the words of Yah and you have them, you're only setting yourself back. You're only neglecting the one who created you. And it's not going to hurt him. It's going to hurt you. So be mindful of what you're doing. I'm the reminder. I am the clear proof. I am here to show you how to consider God easily. How to consider God throughout your day, every day. And how not to be selfish, how to be mindful, be willing to repent, have accountability for your faults. Then you will walk blameless before God. So I don't know who the people have been teaching you guys, trying to say, oh, ain't nobody perfect. No, ain't nobody perfect, but you can follow instructions. Obedience is love. Love is obedience. If you love God, like many of you say you do, obey him. Obey God. And I'm here to show you what God wants from you. And help people who need your help indeed. Because you're going to be in a place of needing help. And the only one that can help you is God. So if you help somebody when you were down, God is going to always help you. I mean, when you're up and they were down. We are commanded to feed the homeless. We're commanded to take care of the hungry, the homeless, the fatherless, and the widows. All right, so I'm going to crack up this Quran, man. I'm going to crack it open, and we're going to get off into some of the beautiful words in here and the advice and the commands that's given to us from our God. All right, so I open it up, and this is where I'm at. Quran chapter 5, verse 72. Quran chapter 5, verse 72. There is one God, not three. All right. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, which interprets, I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the accursed. You must say this before reciting the Quran at any time, all right? Those who say that God is the Messiah, Christ, the Son of Mary, have certainly fallen into disbelief. The Messiah, Christ himself, said, O children of Israel, worship God, my Lord and your Lord. God is my Lord and also your Lord. Worship him alone is what Jesus said. Whoever associates others with God in worship will surely be forbidden paradise by Allah. Their home will be the hellfire, and the wrongdoers will have no helpers. Those who say God is one and a trinity have certainly fallen into disbelief. There is only one God, and if you do not stop saying this, those who disbelieve among them will be inflicted with a painful punishment. We can look around and seeing a lot of things happening to those people who invoke the name of other gods. Last month was Sonya Massey. That's her name. Yeah. She was like, I rebuke you in the name of JC, which is not God. JC is a prophet. Imagine Imagine you saying, God, I'm going to go get my brother to stop you from punishing me. That's basically, because Jesus is just a man. I'm going to stop this person from punishing me. I'm going to rebuke this person by the name of a dead man. Blasphemy, sin, trouble. Black people, stop doing that. If you're a Gentile, stop doing it too. Doesn't, but it's even worse when you Israelites do it. Stop doing it. Jesus is not God. He's a man. Anybody that has to eat food and drink water, they're not God. God created the sun, the moon, the stars, the heavens, the clouds. He created this vast earth. Huge creatures on there. Huge creatures. And it's stuff in the ocean y'all know nothing about. God created all that. He also created the mother of Jesus, who had him through her. So you're going to do God like that? You're going to put God in the state of a baby? I'm only here, listen, if you want to argue, we can debate. And you're not going to win that. And I'm only here to warn you. All right? He says, Jesus, God, and the Spirit are one. That's so, y'all not understanding when y'all read. Y'all should just be quiet and just shut up, because you're associating others with God and worship. So let me explain to you. Jesus was a prophet of God. During the time when Jesus came, the Spirit of God was upon Jesus, which is Gabriel. The Holy Spirit was leading Jesus. Okay? Gabriel is an angel. That's sent from God. God created him. So Gabriel is not God. Gabriel is sent from God, okay? Jesus was also sent from God. So you can't put them all together. God created the angels. If you guys would read scripture and see, this Quran is from God. And his angels are talking in here. So you can't call God a liar. So basically, either you're going to burn in hell or you're going to repent so that you don't burn in hell. So that's what this Quran is here for, all right? All right, so this is chapter 5, verse 68. Chapter 5, verse 68. Adherence to the scriptures. Say, O prophet, O children of Israel, a.k.a. African Americans, you have nothing to stand on unless you observe the Torah and the gospel and what has been revealed to you from your Lord. And what has been revealed to you from your Lord. Yeah, you ain't. So if you ain't reading these books, what you got to stand on? You don't want no smoke with me. What you got to stand on? You don't even read. Make it make some sense. So you mad with me because I'm teaching the truth? You mad with me because I feed the homeless? You mad at me because I teach the children of Israel and all nations of the world that not to lay with women, you must marry them and have a waiting period before marrying them if they laid with a man recently. You guys have never received a perfect religion as this. You never have received that until now. And I am the covenant for all nations of the world. So if you desire to please God, if you desire to know more about him, this is the place for you. And it is called the Straight Path. Alhamdulillah. All right. Clear evidence. All right. Be moderate. All right. Oh, it says evildoers among the Israelites. Okay. Evildoers among the Israelites. Young Money Boy, salute. Appreciate it. Chapter 5, verse 78. The disbelievers among the children of Israel, a.k.a. black folks, were condemned in the revelations of David and Jesus, the son of Mary. That was for their disobedience and violations. So if you read the Psalms of David, if you read the revelations of David, if you read the revelations of Jesus, you're condemned. That means because y'all was breaking Sabbath, y'all was worshiping other gods. That is how we got cursed right now. Right now, the so-called African-Americans are a cursed people. Right now. Indeed. Because of the sins of our ancestors. and the sins that we continue to carry today. All right? David and Jesus, the son of Mary, not the son of man. When Jesus is talked about in scriptures, he's not the son of man. He's the son of Mary. If he was the son of a man, well, who would be his daddy? What man is his daddy? There's no man that's his daddy. You guys are going against what the scriptures say. Jesus has no daddy. He's the son of Mary. Okay. That was their disobedience. That was their for their disobedience. All right. They did not forbid one another from doing evil. So right now, a lot of you guys are going to be punished because y'all see people do evil and you don't say nothing. Y'all see wrong going on and you don't stand up. And when wickedness goes on, you celebrate, you clap. You pour gas on the fire so that they can keep doing evil. So yes, it said in the scripture that in the last days, people would say they would, you know, shun evil. And love, they love evil and shun good. And that's what's happening. All right. You see many of the children of Israel taking the disbelievers as allies. So if you look at my YouTube, I got like over 800 subscribers. You look at the liars, the false prophets, they be having 2,000, 20,000, 100,000 subscribers. 100,000 subscribers, yes, because broad is the way to the path of discretion, all right? You see many of the sinning children of Israel taking the disbelievers as allies. Truly wicked are their misdeeds, which they had earned God's wrath, and they will be in everlasting torment. See, I'm here trying to stop y'all, and y'all mad with me. I look just like y'all, and you want to quickly tell me you ain't no prophet. You ain't no prophet. You ain't Prophet Muhammad. You ain't Deuteronomy 18. What are your proof? Okay, do you want to debate or show me that what convinced you to just say that so quickly and so freely? You say that so quickly and so freely, but it's quick to say, oh, Lil Wayne the best rapper alive. But we ain't got no prophet. Wild. Truly wicked are their misdeeds. Okay, that's true. No lie about that. Which have earned them the wrath of Allah. And they will be in everlasting torment. Had they believed in God? Had they believed in Yah, the only true God? The prophet that's sitting there talking to you right now. God sent you a prophet and I'm sitting talking to you. And I'm reading the scripture. It says, had you believed in God, the prophet. God and the prophet of God, which is here. Why you don't believe? I only tell you to be accountable, feed the poor. Pay alms tax. Don't worship nobody but God. Treat people good. Marry your women. Don't scheme. Don't scam. But you mad with me and I ain't no prophet. Ha! We finna see. Had they believed in God, the prophet, and what has been revealed to the prophet, the Quran, the Dhammapada, these books, the Torah, parts of the New Testament, not Paul, put Paul in the trash. I'm telling you, put Paul ass in the trash. All right. Had they believed in God and the prophet and what has been revealed to them, they would have never taken those pagan sinners that you follow on TikTok and YouTube as allies. But most of them are rebellious. Most of them are rebellious. He say, sorry, I can't follow. Well, yeah, you're going to burn in hell then. All I see is a Nike logo on your picture. I don't know who you is. I tried to help you. Since I can't help you, it ain't my fault. Only God allows you to hear, or he allow you to go astray. He allowed you to hear this truth, and now you're running from it. So, peace. TikTok Center, the day of accountability is near. Yeah, don't y'all... Don't come on here telling me you don't what you don't want to hear. Just scroll. It's easy to just say, shh. Shh. We don't want to hear that negativity, man. It's Friday night. It's plenty of shit you can be doing. Satan got plenty of stuff out here for you. Do it. All right. Chapter 5, verse 70. God took me straight to here. For you children of Israel. Israelites rejecting the prophets. Indeed, we took the covenant from the children of Israel and sent them prophets. Whenever a prophet came to them with what they did not desire, they denied some and they killed others. They thought that there would be no consequences for denying and killing the prophets. So they turned a blind eye and a deaf ear. Yet God turned to them in forgiveness after they repented. But many became blind and deaf. And God is all seeing of what they do. Yeah, so man, the best thing to do, if you don't, just listen. Just be quiet and listen. Because if you reject me, you wrong yourself terribly, man. Terribly. Ain't a person in the world doing what I'm doing. Not one. Not one. And I see Will Smith, he trying. He got way more followers. The man got millions of followers. He trying to do what I'm doing. Won't be able to do it, man. But it's good that he trying. And then, like, even so. It's time for Muhammad to shine. And it's a lot of things out here that you guys are doing and y'all don't even know that the Most High just building you up for me. Wish you well, say you are the truth. That's right. Because of my God, because his will, not because of mine, because of what God has will. Alhamdulillah. Alright, this song, I'm gonna play this song. A lot of y'all gonna know about this song. But this song, you know, I don't know what they're saying yet, but it's teaching you something. All right, if you get mad, God don't want your ass to learn. Just what it is. If you get mad just because I'm playing a song, God don't want you to learn. Be willing to learn. Listen.
I get money, I'm a star.
That's English. That's English.
Star.
I ain't gonna go too deep because we know who it is, but I'm saying that to say this. You're learning Chinese. Have you ever went to class to learn Chinese? Have you ever went to school to learn it? Have you thought to learn it? A lot of you black women, when y'all go into these nail salons, y'all are buying the translators. Y'all want to know what the Chinese people are saying. Yeah, you should. You should want to know what they're saying because it's time to understand one another. All right? So that is why I encourage you. That is why I encourage you to learn other languages. So now just listening to this song, we gonna learn something. So I'm gonna listen to what it's saying. My Mushi. That's the name of the song. My Mushi. Alright. It don't take long. It don't take but a second. Alright. My Mushi meaning. What does my Mushi mean? Alright. So it says, Mamushi means it's a type of snake that's found in Japan. Mamushi is a type of snake. If you didn't know that before you watched this live, now you know it. Mamushi is a type of snake. So Uno Dios. Y'all know what Uno mean. I don't have to. Many of you black people know what Uno mean because we were taught that in our culture, and it's not a English word, is a Spanish word. Uno Dios means one God. Gracias Dios means thank God. Alhamdulillah means thank God in Arabic. Alright. Mamushi. A snake, a Japanese viper. So now you just learn Chinese, you just learn some Arabic, you just learn some Spanish, and we speak English. How long you been on the live? You see what I'm saying? This is how God works. God is working. Let him work. Yeah, everything y'all like to call evil because y'all don't understand. No, it's bigger than what you're saying. It's bigger than what you're saying. Oh, yeah, you say play that song we heard earlier. Yeah, it's a song I heard earlier. I didn't know the lyrics. But now, I mean, I know what the song, the name of the song means in English now. It's beautiful. I'm gonna play it. Here it go. And some of y'all gonna save the song. Some of y'all gonna be like, yeah, it's, you know, cause it flow. You gotta vibe to the beat though, cause you ain't gonna know what she's saying. My boy Victor Beltran though.
Pasando el tiempo presionando, pero yo estoy en el presente. La cosa más bonita, bebé, te
It's called I Deserve It in English.
Bajar la ventana manejando en el carro, sacar el brazo, hacer olas con las manos, agradecer por el mundo en el que estamos, abrir los ojos porque si no chocamos.
Milo Meco. Hi, Amila Meco. Milo Meco. It means I deserve it. I deserve it. Yeah. Milo Meco. So if you this is the Spanish song and they rocking to it. You don't know what they're saying until you start to listen for real. Don't just say, "Oh, I might be casting the spirit in here." No, they think the same thing with you. If they don't know English, every foreign person comes to learn English. Now, this is how powerful English is. A lot of people like to trash English because it wasn't one of the first languages. English is the final, it's one of the languages of this time that's going to bring about the peace. Because I can reach Spanish people through English, I can reach Chinese people through English, I can reach Arabic people through English, I can reach African people through English, I can reach the children of Israel through English. So, yes, this is powerful what we speak, and we have to speak knowledge, mindfulness, consideration, and wisdom. If we want to store up our treasures with God, we want to be good with God, all right? So follow the lead of your wonderful counselor.
Lo que Dios me manda, le digo, ok. Voy flotando por la vida, moonwalking. Aguantando el frío como los hockeys. Ni que llueva se me empañan los oclis. You don't wanna wait for your life to be over. Y que te des cuenta que no te la viviste. Y que también está bien estar triste. Pa' bajar la ventana manejando en el carro. Sacar el brazo, hacer olas con las manos. Agradecer por el mundo en el que estamos. Abrir los ojos porque si no chocamos. Amor de verdad me lo merezco. Salga bien, me lo merezco. Lo bueno viene a mí, la vaina se me da. Hasta la vista al mar me la merezco. Un cielito azul me lo merezco. Una vida cool me la merezco. Lo bueno viene a mí, lo que está para mí viene en camino. Yo me lo merezco. Ya viene llegando, ya me lo merezco. Ya viene llegando, me lo merezco. Ya viene llegando, ya me lo merezco. Guerrera.
Oh, I ain't even try to play this. Y'all ain't ready for this. should I pull it on?
Killing me softly with his song. Killing me softly with his song. Telling my whole life with his words.
Killing me softly. All right.
With his
song. This song is talking about me. I gotta break it down for you after you listen, though.
This is why Clef refuse.
L Boogie up in here, killing me softly with his song, holding you accountable with the words of God while singing. One time.
Hey, yo, L, you know you got the lyrics.
Sang a good song, that's right. I heard he had a style. You see it?
And so
I came to see him and listen for a while. On my live, there you go. And there he was, this young. I'm still young, I got a little gray though. Stranger to my eyes.
Singing my life with his words, killing me softly with this song,
killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life. I had to go get a guitar, y'all.
Killing me softly
with his song. Flushed with fever, embarrassed by the crowd. Embarrassed by what chat saying?
I felt he found my letter
and read each one out loud. I prayed that he would finish, but he just kept right on, strumming my pain with his finger, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song. Prophecy fulfilled. With his song, telling my whole life, with his words, killing me softly. So let me explain it to you a little bit. So the killing me softly is the part of killing the old you, killing the unaccountable you, the person that don't take accountability, the person that won't apologize, the person that ain't been reading about God, the person that ain't been praying on a regularly scheduled prayer life. This right here is hitting home with you. Every time I speak, it's hitting home. Every time. And it's actually killing the old you softly. It's killing you softly. You're gonna become a new person following my teachings. That's what happens. With his song. All right, so it say with his song. What song? I got many songs. God has given me music. All right. God has given the music to me. Psalm 68. You know what it is, believers. Verse 4. Psalm 68, verse 4. All right. Sing praises to Yah, our God. Sing praises to his name. Exalt the one who rides upon the clouds by his name, Yah Almighty, Allah, Yahuwah, Yahweh, whatever beautiful name you call him. Exalt him who rides upon the clouds by his name, Dios. All right, so prophecy fulfilled with the song. I'm strumming the pain with the song. I'm definitely a new person following you, O prophet. Most definitely. Yeah, because, you know, following me, you have to have accountability, consideration, willingness, obedience, and a desire to please your God. Alhamdulillah. If you don't have those characteristics, you're going to be upset with my teachings. And that's okay with me. I just don't want God mad with me. I don't care which of y'all get mad with me. God is the one that I come from, so it is what it is.
With his song,
take me to the bridge.
Y'all, so you gotta break this part down too. Part is the good part. The The woe is the bad. La. See that? Robbie Bunt, salute. One time. Killing me softly with his song. So I go say, do you believe in Allah? What my hat say? Come on, man. Do y'all, I'm teaching. If you just jump right on my live and just ask a question like that, y'all got to start listening first, man. So you won't wrong yourself. You just jump on my live and ask a question. You ain't even listening. Come on and listen first. One God, Dios, uno Dios, Wahid Allah. Wahid Allah. Let me play a song for y'all, man. I'm trying to learn this thing, man. I don't know what I'm doing, but you see how I got me a little posture. Would you stop your sin? All right, we'll try it again later. Praise y'all almighty, man. For his providing. Any questions in the comment section, man? We finna get into this prayer, y'all. We're gonna get into the prayer and we're gonna flow with some more teaching. Put your any questions in the comment section. If not, those who washed up, those who are believers, those who believe in Allah, the last day, and all of his prophets, we are gonna pray prostrate with the prophet as I recite the opening. The prophet as a blessing. Quran 3 and 164. All right. For while I recite this opening, I'm going to play a little music. We're going to have a little background music with this opening. Prayer for guidance. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, most merciful, master of the day of judgment. You alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Guide us along the straight path, the path of those that you have blessed, not the path of those that you're displeased with, or those who are astray. Thank you, Allah, for attending to our prayers. Alhamdulillah. In Arabic, Arudu Lahi Minishaitani Rajim. Bismillah Rahmani Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Rahmani Rahim. Maliki Ya Medin. Iyaka Nabudu Wa. Yaka Nastai, Idana Saroto Mustaki, Sarota Lazina Mata Alehim, Jeril McDobe Alehim, Wala Dalim, Amin. Praise Y'all Almighty Allah forever. Gonna say, and where are we gonna go? Oh, when they find out. Man, it's a beautiful thing that our God taught us the proper way to pray unto him. And if you do not know, you should hit the follow button and take a listen. Tentatively. When they find out, I know we may be rushing, and there's no time to think it through. Cause when y'all overcome, comes your heart, there's nothing you can do. And misery loves company. By now you should know. Misery loves company. That's why the scoffers always saying bad things. Keith Jackson, peace unto you. Good to have you on. Late at night, baby. Preston, salute. Good to have you on, my brother.
I was all alone.
Don't you let no goddamn body come in and tear our love apart. Cause I love you, girl. You are my world. So what are we gonna do? Yeah, somebody on here, so if somebody come on here and they want to challenge me or they saying things, so give them an opportunity to be corrected. Right, that's a good statement. Because Allah may guide them. They're fulfilling their part now, but they may argue with me, but be guided later after I correct them. Because I'm going to bring that scripture to them. Listen, I'm going to bring it to them perfect. Just like scripture say, man, listen. If a person just hate God, they're going to hate me. It's just what it is. I can't make nobody listen or believe. Now, if a person want to argue with me, then y'all can go about your business. I ain't finna be tussling back and forth with you. I could play tennis for that. Come on, huh? We going back and forth. I'm playing tennis. I'm not finna be back and forth with a person that don't listen. Now, if we debate, I'm going to end the debate fast. I'm a fatality. It's more to combat when it comes to debate. Straight fatality. Nobody beats me. Nobody will ever beat me. And God is not, he's perfect, so, and that's who I follow. So if you believe in God and you read his words, we're going to agree. Ilia means one, and or one. Ilia means one God. Ilia means one God. Ilia the greats. All right. Yeah, take them up out of there. Yeah, but Wahid means one. See, it's like y'all, if you know a little, you might know a little Arabic, but Arabic is a huge language. It's people that's Arabic that don't know all of the Arabic words. So one thing you guys have to do is just, you guys know English and probably don't know all, I'm sure you don't know all the English words. So just be willing to learn, man, because I'm not finna be teaching stuff that's wrong. I'm not doing that. Wahid, meaning in English. Man, people playing. I ain't the one. Alright. Wahid means the absolute one. Unique. One of a kind. So... yeah, you learned another word, man. Abdullah says God is a Jewish rabbi title. Man, come on. You just a hater, man. You a hater. You up here sowing. You want to just find something to argue about. There's only one God, sinner. You just want to find something to argue about. BG. Come up and holler at me. Come up and holler at me. You sitting there doing like you got so much knowledge or something. Come holler at me. I'm inviting you. Put your camera on, man.
Let me put a shirt on. Hold on.
Where you at? Come on with it.
It says connect using audio only. I'm pressing the camera button. Ain't nothing coming up.
Well, let me see if I... yeah, it ain't coming up on the camera. You ain't got no camera access. All right, say what you got to say.
Okay. First of all, are you Rasta Muslim? Or do you go by Yahweh? There's different degrees of belief within these different levels.
Well, I ain't on none of them. I ain't on none of them. So if I'm just gonna tell you my name. I'm gonna tell you my name, and after I tell you my name, you just do what you decide with that. I am the Asadullah Farouk. I am Prophet Muhammad. I am the Buddha, the Son of Man, the Elect One, the Seed of David.
You know where all this comes from? The oppression status. Niggas got so beat down, they had to see themselves as superior to the other ones.
That don't make no sense. No, don't tell me where I come from. You tell me where you come from, because it sounds like you come from Satan. I come from Allah, the Lord of all worlds, Yah Almighty, the one who created me for all things and all things for me. So, and for the believers, those who believe in God, he created all this for us. Now, since you are so strifeful on a man's life who's sitting here teaching righteousness and praying, you either state your case and get smoked or be willing to learn and listen, bro, because there's nobody who has the knowledge that I have. And if you want to debate, whatever book you read, you read. Not the ones I read. I read too many for you. Whatever book you read, I'll smoke you in your book. So just be mindful of what you're doing here.
Favor the Bible or Quran?
I love them all.
But do you favor one?
I love them all. Don't play. Yeah, don't try but, to put in my mouth. Don't
okay,
try to.
Dig,
you don't
dig
know
this. Me. Dig this. Do you know that the Bible even lies?
Stop. Lower your voice when you talk to me. First of all, lower your voice when you talk to me. All right, Quran chapter 49. I'm going to recite this. Quran chapter 49, verse 2. Manners with the Prophet. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahmanir Rahim. O believers, do not raise your voices above the voice of the Prophet, nor do you speak loudly to him as you speak to other people, or your deeds will become void while you are unaware. Indeed, those who lower their voices in the presence of God's messenger are the ones whose hearts that Allah has refined for righteousness. They will have forgiveness and a great reward. So now, if you lower your tone now, the Most High will forgive you and you may be rewarded. But if you continue in your high-pitched tone, you will be booted and you will be finna get got by Yah Almighty. So you have an opportunity to unwrong yourself. Here you go.
I apologize for yelling, not because I think you're a prophet. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was the last messenger prophet on earth. There is nothing after him.
Okay. So now since you said that, and I just told you I am the Prophet Muhammad, now you got to show me in the Quran where it says Muhammad died, and Muhammad died 1400 years ago, sinner. And if not, you have to repent. If not, listen, because if we're going to be doing debating and you're going to be saying all of this bullshit on my live, you're going to have to take accountability for it. And if you're right, I will tell the whole world I'm not the prophet of God, and you will win. But first and only man to ever win against me. Now, do you accept these terms? If not, you can keep it moving.
If you cannot prove
in the Quran that Prophet Muhammad is a dead Arab that died 1400 years ago, 1000 years ago, even 500 years ago, if you get that, you win. If not, you got to accept me as the final prophet, apologize on live, and accept me as the final prophet.
Okay, I'll say this. I think and you as the Prophet Muhammad, you should be the walking Quran, right? You're a walking Quran, right?
No, it ain't no walking Quran. It ain't no the walking Quran. The book had to be revealed.
No, I'm, but the Prophet Muhammad that I'm talking about, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was a walking Quran.
Okay, let's see what you're talking about. Let's see who you're talking about. Show me him in the Quran as an Arabic that died 1400 years ago.
Did he die? Yeah. But see, I don't think it's in the Quran. I think it's in Hadith.
Hold on.
And I'm looking in my books now.
Hold on.
I'm looking in my Quran.
And the Quran is the final book. It ain't happened. It's not in the Quran. Tell you he alive and he's talking to you. That's what the Quran say, but you don't believe the Quran. Come on, Mrs. Muhammad.
I just want to ask him, what is your nationality? You can unmute the microphone. What's your nationality? It sounds like you are a child of Israel.
Yeah, thank you, black, blue, black.
Unmute your microphone. What's your
national? I'm a biracial albino.
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know what that means. But anyway,
every nation has albinos, even the mixed ones.
Listen, you are what your daddy is, man, and you must.
Yeah, my dad. I don't even know my dad, so I don't know my tribe.
Okay, see, that's fine. We're not gonna. Well, that's fine. We're not going to go into argument on that or nothing like that. God does what he will. So she just, okay.
You're a child of Israel. You're black. We all know that you're black. You truly believe that God sent a black nation, an Arab prophet to save them.
That's what happened with Isa. Allah sent a man, Isa, who had no father, so he wasn't a child of Israel, and they rejected him.
Okay, but who did he go to? Did he go to the Gentiles?
He went to Israel. He went to Israel only.
He went to Israel only. Okay, so since he went to Israel only, he's not the final prophet.
The final prophet will go to all nations of the world.
That's what Muhammad did.
No, so okay. You saying that Abraham?
I got
a question. Don't try. So you saying that the Arab prophet Muhammad that died 1400 years ago was speaking to all nations of the world?
Mashallah.
You're a liar. That never happened.
You're a walking Quran.
Listen. You're a terrible liar because back then, how could he even know English? The Tower of Babel had already been happened. How could he know English? How could he know the other language to communicate with other people? And then right now, the Arabs keep saying, if you don't know Arabic, you don't know the Quran. They don't even know the Quran. So you're toasted, boy. Ain't nobody went to the nations of the world before me. Nobody. If he did, they will be saved. Y'all would have cut it out, man. Get a real pagan Muslim up here, because this dude don't know what the hell he talking about.
They just want to come up here and argue and get loud. And
yeah, what you loud for? You back raising your voice again.
It's kind of like he take extra testosterone or something. I don't understand why he's so loud.
Well, he gonna understand he shouldn't have been loud. I just asked him a little bit before.
Quran talks about the children of Israel the most. And the reason that the Quran talks about the children of Israel the most is because we are the most disobedient nation on this earth. And this man is up here proving it to be so.
Anybody else want to come up? Anybody got some questions, man? I thought the man was going to try to debate. He can't show us in the Quran that Muhammad died and Muhammad's an Arab. Just show me Muhammad an Arab. Can you show me that?
This is what it is. You a black human being cannot believe in the Bible. What the Bible did, the difference.
Man, we not getting ready to listen to all that scientific bullshit. We listening to the scriptures. Do you have a scripture that you can provide to us?
Okay. And then he said we ain't supposed to, the Bible is for black people. And then it spreads out to all the nations. Man, you done.
I'm gonna read Surah chapter 2, and I'm going to start at verse 75. Arudu Belahi Minishaitan El Rajim. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the accursed. Disobedient Israelites. Do you believers still expect them to be true to you? Though a group of them would hear the word of Allah, then knowingly corrupt it after understanding it. When they meet the believers, they say, oh, we do believe. But in private, they say to each other, will you disclose the believers the knowledge that Allah has revealed to you? So they must use it against you before your Lord. Do you not understand? Do they not know that Allah is all aware of what they conceal and what they reveal? And among them are the illiterate who know nothing about the scripture except for lies. And so they wishfully speculate. So woe to those who distort the scripture with their own hands, then say, this is from Allah, seeking a fleeting gain. So woe to them with what their hands have written, and woe to them for what they have earned. Alhamdulillah.
Smoke. Smoke. Yeah, man, they write their own books. It's a, let me see if I can find that book. It's somewhere around here. If I find them, I'm going to show it to you. Yep, I found it. Woe to you for what your hands have wrote. Boy, you wrote some bullshit in here. Some of y'all probably got this book. Some of y'all probably got this book. Babylon to Timbuktu. Man, I opened this book up and seen some BS about me in here. Oh, I just did it again. Just opened up straight to the lies and BS. Woe to you for what your hand has wrote. It says, Islam and Judaism. The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles of laws from the Jewish religion. Nigga, I'm an Israelite. I'm a Jew. I'm a true Israelite. What are you talking about? You don't even know what you're talking about. First of all, the basic idea of monotheism. There is only one God. Look at my hat. He's saying the basic idea of monotheism. There's only one God. You want to argue with that? You want to debate me? All right. Then it says, which belief in one God? The Jewish confession of the unity of God. Our God is one. It says the Mohammedan slogan is as follows. I am. What? The Mohammedan slogan? Well, let's see. Because if it ain't TikTok sinners, okay. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet. Yeah, that's true. There is no God but Yah, and I'm his prophet. That's what it is. All right. La ilahi illa Allah, Muhammad Rasul Allah. Muhammad adopted also the main details of Jewish calendar, the Day of the Atonement, the Sabbath, and much of Bible narratives. Man, all this is lies. The truth is, I believe in all of the words of God. Our God is a forever God. He's been here forever. He doesn't run out of words. If the oceans and the world were ink and the trees were ink pens, it would have to be, it could be filled up seven times over. It still wouldn't be enough ink and pens for the words of Allah. So, yeah, these people just wrote some falsehood and put it together. And they're lying about me. I believe in all his books. I read the Apocrypha. I have a couple of them. And I actually pass out books. And as the Most High continue to bestow his blessings upon me, and you guys pay your alms tax, people will be able to get books without having to spend money. Well, you pay your alms tax, it's going to come back to you, because alms tax is a creator fund, is a funding for the homeless and the believers. The fatherless, the homeless, the believers, and the widows. It's a fund. That's what alms tax is for, okay? So, believers, if it's about 30, it's about over 30 people on the live now. You pay $21 or $3 a day. If you made $30 a day, $3 would be 10%. What? 10%? Yeah, $3 would be 10%. If you made $60 a day, $3 would be 5% of your earnings. $3 a day or $21 a week. Man, if you need some gas, you need something to eat, the light bill due,
The money gonna be there. It's gonna be there. After 30 people, $20 a week, that's $600. That adds up. 4 weeks in a month. Next thing you know, we making investments in business and land off the alms tax that y'all might have got for the believers and putting people in homes and places to stay. Y'all just gotta do y'all part. Simply, easy. But these books cost money. This right here is on my TikTok shop right now. This is probably the most expensive book. And I make the less money. Don't think, because you pay so much money for this book, I'm making money off this. Nah, you'll see how much I make off of this. This is for your investment into your God. This is what it's all for. Because if I could, you know, put the books together and ship them out, I would do that. But no, these are books that I read and I apply, you know, to my life. And these books are true. There's truth in here. And you hit me up. And if you have any problems with understanding certain things, I'm going to show you what it means. I'm going to tell you what it means. I'm going to do a video. I'm going to break it down so that you understand. So that's why I have so much content on my page. And it'd be about many different things. And we're going to talk about many different things here tonight. But one thing that we should talk about is marriage. Can't hardly hear you, though. You gotta speak up a little bit.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, before you go into that, I do want to say to all of the believers, like, we know how much these books changed our lives. We know that we are commanded to distribute the scrolls to people who want to change their lives. So, you know, pay your alms tax. Or if you see new people that's on the live that say, I wish I had a book, inbox them and say, hey, I'll send you a book to your house. These are things that we're commanded to do. And all of these books saved my life. I know they did.
This person say the Quran is sufficient for us to know God. Well, if you didn't read the Torah or the Bible, that means you wouldn't even know what God to go to. The Quran is a later revelation. It's the most perfect book on earth. But it's the final revelation. And it's a book that's given to me. And it's a religion that's given to me for all the people of the world. So if you ain't learning from me, you don't have the fullness of the Quran. And if you think you've been putting peace upon a prophet who is dead, you're sadly mistaken.
May I read Moshe's scripture before we talk about marriage?
Yes.
Surah chapter 23. Starting at verse 39, and it's called The Blast. The messenger prayed, "My Lord, help me, because they have denied me." Allah responded, "Soon they will be truly regretful." Then the mighty blast overtook them with justice, and we reduced them to rubble. So away with the wrongdoing people. Alhamdulillah, that's beautiful.
Ain't it? We're going to have peace on the earth. Ain't going to be no wicked people. There's going to be peace and righteous people who all will know their God. Yeah, listen, y'all, I know y'all see y'all be saying, man, the world wild, it's crazy, we're in the last days. Yeah, but we're finna get a new heaven and a new earth. And it's gonna be peace on earth. Yeah, because the truth is here and falsehood will disappear. Yes, indeed. Falsehood is bound to disappear.
Praise Yah.
Forever. So now with the marriage. This is so getting married is belief in God. Not you know, rushing and forcing some shit now because you see a person going to church or you know that somebody say they a man of God. Nah. That ain't, God has to make the connection. When you start seeing things that only you prayed for and it's happening quickly and it's so beautiful, and that's God. You telling somebody, let's go to church or, you know, this and that. No, you have to test people. You have to be patient and things will show up. You'll see things, you'll see signs. And that's why the Most High wants the believing women and men to follow me, so that they can be guided on the right path and they won't have to go through all of these mistakes and these traumatizing experiences throughout their life. We all have wronged ourselves in many ways, but don't be the reason. Don't you be the reason. that you messed up, because you're only accountable for yourself. Marriage. So if as a man, you desire marriage because it's pleasing to your God. As a woman, the Most High put it in you to want to desire your husband. And when you know, when you hear your husband, see your husband, you'll know, you're going to know, because you're going to have a desire in you. And then he's going to make it so that he's the only one that can fulfill that desire. And I'm talking about righteous husband. I ain't talking about no man that you left or somebody that's back and forth. You do your part and you're going to know, you're going to be like, wow, every day you're looking forward to him, because him teaching you about God has changed your life and makes your life now adventurous. Ask Mrs. Yator. She's been with me, what, about 3 years now?
Three?
You think it, well, you think it's, well, it could be four. I mean, I believe, yeah, about 4 years ago, I was back where I was cutting hair. I know right now I was cutting. I was at work 4 years ago, sure.
September will be four.
Oh yeah, so yeah, we getting up. I seen some haircuts on my page, and it was, yeah, 4 years ago. It was 4 years ago. I was in the, yeah, but when I met you, I said, man, I ain't gonna be in the shop all day long and doing that.
Earlier, I think I told somebody we've been married for 6 years, but anyway, God bless us.
I know it be feeling like that, because that's the bond we have. And the time has sped up, to be honest with you. Everybody's days are going by faster. So, and we don't get, I ain't finna get mad at her for not knowing no specific time. And she, I ain't finna allow no woman to all mad with you because you don't know the exact date. We don't do that. I didn't teach my wives that. I had to teach my wives. I didn't come in and let them teach me. Because now you can learn. I'm not saying that you can't learn things from your wife. You can. But on the aspect of how your relationship goes and things that you guys weigh as important and things that you, you know, just you have to make things important. And this is your God. The mindfulness of your God. And making him important is loving my wives. Why is that? Wonderful counselor, Yanabi. Because he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from Yah Almighty. So why would I neglect my good things and my favors from God? I would rather invest into them.
That's powerful, old prophet.
That's what we're supposed to do. That's what we're supposed to do as men, though. Yeah, I know they say women build a man up. We build each other up. Yeah, and we build each other up.
So I had a conversation with the most beautiful women today. There was three of them. And I mean, they had smiles that were, I've never seen smiles like what they had today. They really brightened my day. And just speaking with them, the only thing that women want from men is to be led in the right direction.
Righteous women, or women.
Righteous women.
Care about God. I've met some women that just want every man to obey them. I've met some women that want every man's attention, and they didn't care about God. So when a woman cares about God and desires to learn about him, they want to be led.
Exactly. So you have men out here that, you know, are saying that they're leaders and they're leading their women and this and this and that, but they're leading them to a path of destruction. They're leading them to believe that Jesus is God. They're leading them to, you know, do things like go to church and put crosses around their necks, which is idolatry. They're leading them to the path of destruction.
Oh yeah, they definitely, and it's been going on for a long time. But what has to happen is the woman has to take accountability for her actions and mistakes.
Yes.
To understand that she's been loving Mr. Wrong.
Yep. Yep.
Mr. Wrong and get along so good, you know he hurt your heart so bad. That ain't nothing special y'all got going on. That's evil. You have to admit it. And then when Mr. Righteous comes into your life is a whole new start. It's like it's your first love ever. Because
yes.
Your first angel.
Hallelujah. I can attest to that. I just told you the other day, this is amazing. What we have is different. It's amazing. It's fulfilling. It's beautiful. I love it. And I just, every day when I wake up in the morning and I see you, I just feel brand new all over again.
Yeah, it's like sunshine seeing you every morning. And I thank y'all almighty for that. But when I wake up, I'll be like, I had to wipe that, man. You know, the first words I say is praise y'all almighty, alhamdulillah, gracias Dios. Them will be the first word come out of my mouth in the morning. So, you know, inshallah, to wake me up, the Most High can take us whenever he get ready. He can hit me at night and be like, well, I'm going to take you up into the heavens like I did Enoch. Tell him bye. Yeah, the Most High has no limits, and I'm just with it. So I thank him for every moment with, you know, my wives and my family. And, you know, you will truly know when a person is from God, and you'll know when a person is from Satan, too.
So there's a song by Cam. Is it his name, Cam? Can you play Cam? Is it In Love Again?
Oh, you're talking about, I know.
Uh-huh, that smile on your face. You know what I'm talking about.
this song right here is also on the, it's on the Yahweh playlist. If you guys haven't got that playlist, you can get it. Alright, you're gonna have I know y'all are gonna be bumping this.
Yeah, they're gonna be in there slow dancing.
Yeah, they're gonna dance to this one. Y'all gonna get your dancing shoes on, Mrs. Yael and Mrs. Yael. There you go. Gonna get your dancing shoes on. You gotta put your hand behind the bike. Slide with it. You gotta get yourself some room on the floor, all right?
Where are we? Right, we gotta fast forward a little bit.
Oh, that's a little bit.
They do a skit at the beginning.
Oh yeah, this show. Yeah.
Yes.
Every day I wake up in my feelings for you. And I imagine always I wanna love you, girl. This aching, it's divine, and it's taking me back in time to the moment we met and how I waited for you to tell me all these little things about you. Put away that your favorite movie, you were made in heaven. Just told me I'm in love again. Then you got the message that I'm in love again. Then you got the magic touch, I'm in love again. I'll do whatever you want me to do, in love again.
And that's how y'all might feel about his service, too.
You
opened up, honest and true.
I'm no
longer in this world without you.
Maybe I'm stuck in time.
Oh, we flowing your heart
right at home
next to mine.
Hey, why you stay?
Slide with her, y'all. Slide with her. I see you, y'all humble. Where your woman at? Get her right now.
You're amazing, and
just your man, I'm your lady, I'm in love again. You got the gang switched up, I'm in love again. You got the magic touch, I'm in love again. We do not own the rights to this music. YouTube do not take this down. All right, I'm gonna stop it for teaching purposes. We're gonna pause it because they like to remove sounds when we upload the live. But yeah, this is for educational purposes. Live Out Your Love is the name of this song. It's by Kim, K-E-M. Live Out Your Love. Yeah, man. And but this song, like, it played or something when we was together. You know, it just when it played, though, we went into this, the divinity of the song. And it's something that you can never, every time it played, we always remember. But live out your love, and your love is in God. And that's the only way that you'll find true love. Outside of Him, you're only going to find hardship and trouble. And as we can see, we are in the end times. So however much time that the Most High has given you, make sure you use this time properly to love and adore those that you love. All right?
I'm going to jump down. It seemed like I'm causing a lot of static on the live.
All right. If you got to come back up for the base or come up for some advice or anything like that, just be willing to come back.
I'm always willing, no problem.
Praise Yah Almighty.
Praise Yah.
I'm in love again. Yeah, man. So as a man, you know, that's been through heartbreaks and people who don't fulfill their promises and their covenants, the Most High also went through this. And I had to learn, you know, how to go about this from the Most High. The children of Israel didn't fulfill their covenant with Him. And I see how it felt, you know, and with women who doesn't fulfill their covenant with you, whether it's a failed marriage, a divorce, a relationship that didn't work out, somebody lied, infidelity, it all hurts, man. And you just wasted time, or you just basically then threw everything, all the love back into a man's face. So that is why the Most High is so upset with the children of Israel and put them on a curse. Because of what they did. They did idolatry, which is adultery. Yeah, so God took our names and named us after our oppressor. He took our land and He took our kings and our priests, and He made us servants and slaves. Yep, and we still are. Yeah, but when you understand what you're serving for, and you understand what our ancestors did and what we should do to better ourselves, we have the opportunity to do that, to make things right. And He has in store for us, after all of this test, land. I'm talking about abundant land with milk and honey and beautiful wine and beautiful fruits and trees and just rivers like you've never seen before. So that's for people who do good and who believe in God. All right. Is divorce a sin? Unrighteous divorce is a sin. Divorce is not a sin. Unrighteous divorce is a sin. And when I mean unrighteous, it's like, okay, you as a man, you stop. You want to leave your wife because she just, you know, you want to leave her just because you want to leave her. She might not be listening right now, or, you know, but she ain't committing no adultery and she ain't terribly wrong, dude. She just wronging herself right now. You got to have patience, man. You can't just leave a woman because she might be tripping or something, because women, they got to be led. So she got to be willing to be. So if she don't want to listen, and then so there are steps to this. If the woman doesn't want to listen, there's things that we can do. All right. So we're going to talk about it. All right. Since you asked about divorce, I'm going to read that proper way to divorce. This is Quran chapter 2, verse 229. Ha'udu Balahi Mene Shaitani Rajim. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the accursed. Alright, it says, divorce. A divorce may be taken back twice. Then the husband must retain his wife with honor or separate from her with grace. It is not lawful for husbands to take back any of the dowry given. So you gotta pay your wives, man. I know y'all ain't been doing it. I'm talking about before you marry them. If you're finna marry a woman, you gotta let them know, look, this is it. Here go a security deposit. You know what I'm saying? It's to let you know I ain't playing. And if you choose to change your mind before it's time for us to get married, you just keep that. I'm good. Y'all Almighty provides. Alhamdulillah. All right. So you are to pay dowries. Now, if your wife is like, no, your wife got the bag already, she just desire your knowledge, that's just what it is, that's fine. But we are the caretakers of women. We got to lead them. We got to provide for them. You know what I'm saying? So don't try to, you know, this what it is. All right? So it is not lawful to take back the dowry given for the wives unless a couple of fears of not being able to keep within the limits of God. Now, if you feel like you just can't take it, like, okay, that was your last and you're going to just go off the handle. Yeah, go on, get you, because, yeah, bro, you just, you're not listening to the prophet. Now, the Most High don't want you to be like that over money and stuff. You know what I'm saying? The Most High provides. So if whatever you give, don't ask for it back. That's what it is. If you put $1,500 on it, she like, well, it just ain't going to work out. Yeah, keep that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Matter of fact, do you need some more money to leave? You need some more money to leave? Because by you leaving right now, you're doing me a great favor. You see what I'm saying? Like, God is going to give you the best advice. And this is the advice right here. All right. So if you fear that they will not be able to keep within the limits of God, there is no blame if the wife compensates the husband to obtain divorce. All right. So if you feel like your husband ain't going to be righteous or he ain't doing what's right, you can pay his ass. You can be like, look, you ain't rightly guided, and I need somebody who rightly guided. Let me give you $3,000, man, and you forget my number and forget everything we. And shit, I mean, hey, that's the proper way to sell it. You don't want no beef. You don't need nobody hunting you down and try to use your name on a tax ID document and stuff. You don't want none of those problems. Leave peacefully. Pay somebody who want to leave. Just go. All right. What if your husband deceitful calling the Most of them is a lie? So this is what I'm talking about here. You know, if you feel like you can't keep within the limits of Allah, there's no blame if the wife compensates the husband to obtain divorce. Hey, man, listen, you on the bullshit. I'm just going to pay you to leave. You can get you a flight with this right here. You can get you an apartment with this right here. Hey, here you go. Take some of this tax money. May Allah guide you. Yeah, I'm not teaching y'all to do bad breakups. I'm not teaching y'all to do anything bad in a relationship. You married, we don't do nothing forceful. We ain't, listen, ain't what you heard about Islam, true Islam marriage, it was wrong. This is the best for women. This protects women. This actually makes sure it's the best for everybody. All right, it says, all right, let's see. So divorce, it's called divorce before compensation, consummation. Divorce before consummation. So if you plan to marry somebody, or I plan to marry somebody, and this, we're going through the 90-day waiting period, and upon day 65, she just like, oh, you know what? You know, I think it's a little too much for me, man. I think we shouldn't, and we ain't laid, you know, you ain't laid down with her, or I ain't, you know, it's all good. So this is what happens. It says, there is no blame if you divorce a woman before marriage is consummated, before you have sex with her, or before you pay her the full dowry. But give them a suitable compensation. Now, if you ain't paid the money yet for the marriage and she talking about she want to leave or you want her to leave, you still have to compensate her. You can't let a woman go broke. You can't say, well, you ain't got no gas in the car. Get it how you get it. Nah, hold on. Let me fill your tank up. Let me make sure you straight. Now, if they leaving and cheating and they talking about another man, or they trying to leave for another man, you're not helping nothing. Nah, you got to tell that man to help you. Ask him to save you. That's a whole different. I'm not funding you to go to another man. So, all right, it says, there's no blame if you divorce a woman before marriage is consummated. Or a dowry is settled. Give them a suitable compensation. The rich according to the means of, and the poor according to his means. So if you know you a millionaire, ain't no way you supposed to be giving this woman $2,000. Now, if you're a working man, you a hard working man, you know what I'm saying? And you know, you just. Yeah, nah, yeah. If you give $1,000 to leave, then if you can, that's the means you make. If you got $500, the means you make is according to what you got. If you ain't got no job, you ain't supposed to be trying to get married. You ain't got no income coming in. Your ass don't need to be laying down with nobody. You need to be getting right with God and asking Him to provide for you. It happens. I mean, I've been in a state of not having. But God provides. It's not time to be trying to be making children and sexing and stuff like that. That's why probably a bunch of depressed babies and troubled children are out here now, because y'all laying with all these sad, depressed and broken and men who just drunk out of their mind on these spirits, these alcohol spirits and stuff. Yeah, man, y'all be drinking a bottle that say spirits on it. Is it a sin to drink? No, it's not a sin to moderately drink, but if you're drinking all the time and you're going out here and these clubs all the time and these fucking rap events and stuff, y'all know y'all out there with the gangsters and the demons and shit, man. Y'all know that. What y'all think is in the streets? What y'all think in the streets? Yeah, you going to these places, you go, it's possible you can find righteousness in these places. It's possible. Sometimes I might pop out. I ain't popping out getting drunk and messed up trying to, and you know, if you pop out, you popping out with everything. It's going to be, the worst of the wicked. It's going to be the snakes. It's going to be gin, all this out here. So if you getting, y'all running into these people y'all dealing with in these places, what do you think you expect to get? That's what you expect to get. That's what you got. Now, if I'm out in one of these places, club, a game or something, I know that I got to teach you, but I know that what's the chance I'm running into a devout, righteous woman out here? And then they probably, most of y'all be showing everything. Everybody looking like, dang, everywhere you look, you see, you just like your eyes just full. Yeah, that ain't love, man. That ain't love. That's just temporary desire. And that is why there's all these children out here and a bunch of single mothers doing it on their own. Them niggas don't care, man. They ain't even paying for y'all babies to go to school and stuff. You ain't going to no club. Oh, I used to, though. I was the prophet in the club. I was in the night, you know what I'm saying? I was in the club talking about God. I'm just saying, like, people, God do what he want to do. I ain't going to say he ain't. If he did, I'm still me. I ain't finna be misled by no temptation. I ain't finna be misled by no none of that. I'm me where I'm at. You can put me in Alaska, you can put me at the ends of the earth. I'm still Prophet Muhammad. It is what it is. Alhamdulillah. That's why he sent a real man that's going to keep it real with you. He ain't sent nobody fake. He sent a real person that got real experiences. But no, I ain't going in the club looking for no wives and stuff. Could you find one out of there? It's possible. But if you're going in there looking, you ain't looking for no wives. You just trying to lay something down. That's all you're trying to do. Since I moved to Mississippi, no one said anything about my husband. Well, you know how I be with your family and stuff, man. They actually be, they be wanting shit to happen so you can come back home and say that what happened and talk about them and stuff. So they don't want you to be successful. And since you're happy and they see you happy and they probably see it on your posts and stuff like that, they just sitting back waiting and watching. They just wait for something to happen and watching. So those are people you got to prove wrong. Man, it's people like that. That's what they do to everybody. Whenever you come into the truth about serving your God and you loving your husband, this is going to happen to your family, so-called friends. This is going to happen. So, believers, if you're not married, you're single, if you're believing in the truth, you want to know more about God, you got to be willing to lose some hating-ass people that you needed to lose. Not lose, you gotta get rid of them. You're gonna have to be willing to get rid of the dead weight. The Most High gonna be cutting their ass off. They gonna be getting mad at you. They gonna be like, you follow this guy. He did this or he do this. They just gonna be saying all type of evil stuff. Or you pray how many times a day? Why you pray so much? Or why you washing up before you pray? So you can talk to God too much? Ain't living and breathing is being an example of God? Come on, man. People got to have, they got to be more mindful, man. But yeah, your marriage is what you make it. You can't worry about what people think. So if nobody asks me about my wife, that's fine. That's cool. I know about her. I'm, you know, and shit. And I'm enjoying what the Most High has for me. So yeah, I don't know. Yeah, if nobody don't ask about if my family anything, I'm loving them. I'm doing my part and God is doing so. That's all I care about. You have to be that way in these times because a lot of people gonna change up on you. You gotta be ready for that. Never too much of y'all. That's what's gonna keep you on path. So five times a day, that's actually, you know, I mean the Most High knows more than we do. He's all knowing. I don't, so I thank him just for revealing it to me. You know, before it was revealed to me, I did pray. I don't know if it was how many times. I probably prayed more, but I wasn't washing up before prayer. I did always wash up before the lives, though. So that's why I know, like, when it came before, you know, when it came, when the revelation came to me, I was, like, amazed because I already knew that my intimate time with Yah was when I was washing up, and that's what I would pray, and that's when I would, you know, ask for forgiveness and stuff. And when the Quran was revealed to me, it was telling me how to wash my, you know, from my elbows to my hands and wash my face and my head and my feet. I was like, wow. When I first did it, you know, it was just so amazing, and the feeling, and it's like it's so intimate with Yah. And I just knew then, I was just like, wow, it's just how everything he's revealed. It's so, we all grow. Moses had to grow. Moses wasn't born and knew everything. He was being taught. He was being taught by people that was teaching him. He was learning. So even Jesus, he had to learn. He had to grow. Esau, Yahusha, Yeshua, Yahawashi, he had to grow in knowledge. So this is what Muhammad is doing. He's has growth and knowledge. You can see over the years, I've been teaching for over a decade, but as you can see, every time you'll see nothing but growth. You'll see change and growth. All right. The only one that wants me to be successful is my mother. Yeah. So you gotta inspire people. That's why you put content out. And, you know, you're going to start inspiring people who think like you, and you're going to start getting support. This is where you guys come from. I mean, it's Yah Almighty sent you guys, and he wanted you guys rightly guided. Those who stay to the end, some people are going to turn, it happens. But, you know, Yah Almighty guides who he wills. But, yeah, when you guide it, man, that's a beautiful thing. And, you can't, you know, your support will grow when you meet more people that, you know, love God and that's mindful of God. So, yeah, man, yeah, I've been the whole time I was Muhammad, but my support was small. Now my support has grown, and as you can see, over 33,000 followers on TikTok. So the word of God is fulfilling. The words of God, the perfect words of God are fulfilling. That's why I never join the camps. They never admit fault. Yeah, them niggas tripping, man. That's why, yeah, they be thinking they like God or something. Nah, buddy. I got it. So this is the thing. God see our thoughts and our heart, right? So this is going to help you be righteous. You won't be a sinner if you live like this. Whatever God see you do, dog, if you don't do right, you got to make it right. You got to make it right in his face. Where can you hide from God? Good question, Lanny. You don't hear nobody asking that but me. Where can you hide from God? You can't hide nowhere from God. So the foolish thoughts that come in your mind before you do something foolish or anything that come to your mind, he see that. You got to make it right, man. So yeah, if anything foolish even come to my mind, I know God saw that. I can't just act like he ain't see it and not do nothing or say nothing. You know what I'm saying? So if you can correct yourself before you even do anything, correct it in your mind, you will never be a sinner again. Never. It's that simple and easy. You are what you think. If you think you are old, broke ass, nothing ass nigga, I promise that's what you're going to be. I promise you. For you, if you call yourself a servant, a willing servant who takes accountability, that's what you're going to be, man. You're going to be that. And when you're wrong, you're going to be like, my bad, bro, my bad. I take that back. How can I make it right? You know, everybody who do that, you won't even know the wrong they did because they made it right so fast, like you won't even, it's nothing to dwell on. When you do a good deed, you don't have to repent for good deeds. You only have to repent for doing bad things. So do more good things so that you don't have to repent for nothing. And I do so many good things that when you see me, I'm always walking upright. I'm always walking with my head upright because I know I did well. And I know my God is watching me and protecting me. Yeah, you see me out walking, you'll see the light on me. You'll see me with that walk. Yes. So I know I see it. Alhamdulillah. Allah is all seeing, all knowing. Hey, can I ask a question about Jesus and Islam? Sure. Sure. Area said, I'm here to stay always and forever. That's beautiful, Area. Alhamdulillah, mashallah. Surah 7 and 36 is what makes me move gracefully throughout the day. Let's read it. So that's what page, love? What page is it? Surah 7 and 36. Do things and don't talk about it. Nah, you can talk about it to your husband or something, you know, like, don't talk about it. Man, I help people. I have to help people. So people, when they come back, they be, oh, that's that guy right there. I don't ask their name. I just do what I do and keep it moving. I tell them it's from Allah, it's from Yah Almighty. I tell them. So, yeah, it feel good to do good stuff. Yeah, let your people know you're doing good so they can actually race with you. We supposed to actually compete with one another in doing good. You know, yeah, just ain't nobody going to compete with the prophet. I'm talking about the believers. You know, give. You can't overgive to God. So if you're giving to a homeless person and all you got is $100 and you don't know where the next, you know where the next money come from. If you ever even say you don't know where your next money coming from, you can't truly believe. Everything we get comes from God. So yeah, give your last and then you gave that to God. That's for God. That's for Allah. Alhamdulillah. Man, you might get a $10,000 check in the mail tomorrow talking about they had some type of claim on T-Mobile that you had a T-Mobile phone for that 5 years. You never know. That's how God works. That's how God works. So give. Be a giver. Page 55. All right. Ever since I've been giving more, my life has increased. At first, I would help people, but I wouldn't give to everybody. I would be passing by folks and all that, like, nah, nope, shoot. Now, shoot, I see anybody looking like they begging, look, I'm, because it's the revelations. It's just the revelation given to me. Now, there's still people that I will reject. And it's those people who I have helped for so long and they never did anything for me. I help them and they don't even come to the live or listen. They don't share no content. I'm popping. God got me lifted up. But if you know me and you ain't sharing nothing and you know Muhammad, come on, bro. Like, so when you in times of need and you hit me up, I can't give you nothing, bro. I can't not, because I know already. I didn't, and it ain't because I already, because you don't believe in God, bro. So if people believe in God, if you believe in the Most High, shoot, you ain't got it everywhere. Every time you ask me, I got it. If I got it. But yeah, the Most High, he say, don't give to those who don't believe in him. All right, Sirach. Page 55, so about 7:36. Alright. So is it 7:36 or 7:35? Alright, 7:36. Alright. In all your words, remember eternity, and you will never sin. Wow, that's beautiful. In all of your words, remember eternity, and you will never sin. The eternity is hereafter. And that's, so this right here, it verifies the words I'm speaking to y'all. It confirms that I am the word of Allah. It confirms. And crazy, what was a revelation that wasn't crazy, but it was a revelation. I used to didn't believe in Jesus, Yahusha. I just thought it was all idolatry, which believing he God is idolatry. But before it was revealed to me that he was real, I used to, you know, the Most High had to reveal to me my level of consciousness of not being a sinner anymore. There is, you know, I hadn't been so it's been probably about a decade now that I haven't been sinning. Like, I haven't been a sinner. Now, have I sinned? Yeah, we make mistakes. We people, I ain't perfect. That's why I got to repent. The Son of Man has to repent, you know, and I was sinning by saying Jesus, you know what I'm saying, wasn't, he didn't exist. That's a sin. So I repent for that sin because I didn't know. I wasn't here. But I did know that he wasn't the prophecies of the Bible. The prophecies of the Bible were about me, and they all lined up perfectly. And anybody who debated me, I always won because the prophecies was about me. So God always had me rightly guided. But when the Quran came, he corrected me with the Quran. He was like, oh, prophet. Oh, yeah, Jesus was a prophet. And he did this and he did that, and you need to believe in him. Because if you don't believe in him, yeah, you are the prophet, but we'll burn you in hell too. Hold on, I had to read it again. Like, what? Yeah, oh prophet Muhammad. Your book right here, the Quran, this is your book. You rejected this book before, thinking that the prophet Muhammad was an Arab man. You rejected this book. Now that we have revealed to this book to you that you didn't know was going to happen, you got to believe in Jesus as a prophet of God, not as God, because you know he ain't God, but you got to believe him as a prophet of God, or we're going to burn you too, right here in this book. Man, I don't want to burn. No, I don't want to be burned by a lighter, a cigarette lighter. Let alone hell fire. So yeah, I repented immediately and came on live, and I was like, y'all, look, the angels was there, I wasn't there. And you know, Jesus was a real person. He ain't God. Now we on point by that. And if you believe he God, you're gonna burn in hell. But he real. And he was a prophet. And he said that before you will be stoned if you commit adultery with another man's wife. Okay, if you lay with another man's wife, you commit adultery. You should be stoned, both of y'all. But I say unto you now that if you look upon, if you think upon having sex with her in your mind, you have committed adultery. Now, before I was enlightened, I couldn't get the understanding of that verse. It just wasn't time. The Most High wasn't, it wasn't time yet. But when the enlightenment came, that's what I teach. I was teaching that before I found out he was real. If you think it in your mind, you did it. Right now, if you think in your mind about doing harm to somebody, taking from somebody, doing something evil to them, you did it. You're going to be charged for that by God. Especially if you know some people, everybody, you did it. You ain't have to ever do it with your hands. That was a real confirmation that, you know, okay, I know he a true prophet now. You know, after reading the Quran first, I knew that was perfect. The Quran was a perfect book. But seeing that my teachings, what I was teaching, that's what he was teaching. He was teaching that, what I'm teaching. If you think it in your mind, you did it. So yeah, my level, I apologize to him, and my level of respect, man, is so utmost for any of the righteous, man. Abraham, Moses, Enoch, all of them, Jesus, Esau, Joshua. My level of respect is so utmost. And he in here saying some of the most beautiful stuff about me. Jesus told God that he wanted to meet me. And he felt that he wasn't worthy enough to tie my shoestrings. He said that, man. He said that. And I felt so bad about how, you know, I would tear his name down and, you know what I'm saying, for so many years. And he's sitting here bigging me up. He's sitting there right here in the book of Barnabas. Listen what he say. Listen what he say about me right here. I had to apologize. So yeah, I'm going to tell y'all the truth about Jesus. That's why when you look on my page, you'll see the truth about Yahusha, Yeshua, whatever name you call him. You'll see the truth about him. You're going to get the true stories about him from me. He did not die on the cross. He did not die for the sins of mankind. No, he didn't. All right. All right. This is what he said. Let's see. All right, here it go. Chapter 96. We just read this other one. Thought saying God was a sin. No, man. God is a part of language, man. I'm gonna get to you right after this. Let me get. I hope we can carry on with this one. Yeah. Saying God is a sin. That's crazy. All right. Chapter 96, Book of Barnabas. In the book of Moses, it is written that our God, Allah, must send us the Messiah, who shall come to announce to us what Allah wills, and shall bring the entire world, the Gentiles and the Israelites, the mercy of Allah. Therefore, I ask you to tell us the truth, Jesus, Yahusha, Yahawasha, Isa. Are you the Messiah of God that we should expect? And Isa answered, it is true that Allah has promised, but indeed I am not he. For the Messiah, the one you look for, was made before me, and he shall come after me. And the priest answered, by your words and signs, at any rate, we believe you to be a prophet and a holy one of God, whereby we ask you in the name of all Judea and for the love of God, tell us how will the Messiah come? And Jesus answered, as Allah lives in whose presence my soul stands, I am not the Messiah that all the tribes of the earth should expect. Even as Allah promised our father Abraham, saying, in your seed, I will bless all the tribes of the earth. But when God shall take me away from the world, not kill me, not let some sinners kill me. When God shall take me away from the world like he did Enoch, Satan will raise again this accursed sedition by making the impious believe that I am God and I'm the Son of God, where my words and my doctrine will be contaminated, insomuch that scarcely shall remain about 30 faithful people, whereupon God will have mercy upon the world and will send his messenger Muhammad, who he has made all things for, and who shall come from the south with power and shall destroy the idols with the idolaters, who shall take away the dominion from Satan over men, and he shall bring with him the mercy of Allah for salvation to them who believe in him and he who believe in his words. Perfection. Perfection. Let's go to the book of Enoch. Let's go to the book of Enoch, chapter 1st Enoch. Let's do 1st Enoch, I think it's 62. Yeah, I think it's 62. Oh, yes, Enoch 62. The fact that I stated God is not the name of the fathers. How is there a father in heaven? So he got a wife? Y'all don't even be knowing what y'all are saying. Y'all say some of the most foolish stuff about God, man. God ain't got no children, bro. So he got his female angels? Come on, man. Y'all be tripping. God is the creator. He created the sun. He didn't birth the sun. He didn't birth the water. He didn't birth the earth. He didn't birth you. He ain't birthed Jesus. He created us. We came from the dust of the, we came from the dirt. And God is not a father. Do you have a child? I'm a father. Don't put me in comparison to my God. He created me. Y'all just get so disrespectful and don't understand how disrespectful you get. God don't want to be called no father. That's you putting him low like he a man or something. He ain't no man. He created all this. He can shut it all down if he wanted to. Yeah, man, if you come on here to learn, you can come learn. Don't be trying to come on here and put no confusion in my life, bro. You ain't finna be teaching. You ain't teaching nothing on here, man. The teacher is right here. That guy live in a fairy tale, like them baby form angels. Yeah, they look. You see the angels. You see the little baby angel with the wings. That's what he believe. Foolish ass shit, man. We don't do none of that over here. Now, if you want to come up and talk to me, yeah, because you're doing. You want to come up and talk to me, you can do that. I'm finna read this scripture though. Yeah, y'all be geek for the spotlight, man. But you got 24 followers. Ain't nobody listening to you. And ain't nobody finna be listening to you on here neither. Out of here. 1st Enoch chapter 62. And so Yah Almighty commanded the kings and the mighty, the exalted, and those who dwell upon the earth, and said, open your eyes and lift up your horns if you are able to recognize the chosen one. And Yah Almighty, Allah, seated him on the throne of his glory. And the spirit of righteousness was poured out on him. The word of his mouth. And the word of his mouth slays all sinners. And all of the unrighteous are destroyed before his face. And all the kings and the mighty and the exalted and those who hold the earth will stand up in that day. And they will see and recognize how he sits on the throne of glory. How he sits on his throne of glory. They're going to see and recognize me. They're going to be scrolling. You see how I'm sitting? Look at the posture. I'm on my throne of glory now. And righteousness is judged before him. right? And no lying word is spoken before him. See, every time y'all lie, I correct it. I ain't gonna let nobody come on here and lie. I correct you. Prophecy fulfilled. Verse 4, then pain will come on them, the sinners, the disbelievers. Pain will come on them as a woman in childbirth when her child enters the mouth of the womb. And she has pain bringing out. And the disbelievers will look upon the believers and they will be terrified. And they will be downcast in their conscience. And pain will seize them when they see that Son of Man sitting on the throne of his glory. And the kings and the mighty and all who possess the earth shall bless and glorify and exalt him, Yah Almighty, who rules over all and who was hidden. From the beginning of creation, the Son of Man, Muhammad, was hidden. And the Most High has preserved him in the presence of his might and has only revealed Muhammad to the chosen people. And has only revealed Muhammad to the chosen people. Wow. Talk about John 1 and 1. Talk about John 1 and 1. This is 1 Enoch chapter 62. It says, from the beginning, the Son of Man, which is me, Muhammad, was hidden. That means nobody, I was already here in celestial splendor, wasn't born as a human on earth. And I was prophesied in the scriptures, and I know only people that can know about me were the believers of the end time. All right. From the beginning, the Son of Man was hidden. We know this ain't talking about Jesus because he ain't got no daddy. He ain't the Son of Man. He's the Son of Mary. If y'all try to debate that, you already lost. It's over. All right. The Most High preserved him in celestial splendor. We get the priest, we get the connector right here in the Gospel of Barnabas and in the Torah of the Bible. We have that. Whose goings were from old to everlasting. Whose goings were from old to everlasting. This is the explanation. All right. And the congregation of those who are chosen, the holy ones, will be sown, and all of the chosen ones will stand before him on that day. And all of the kings and the mighty and the exalted who rule the earth will fall down on their faces and worship before and set their hope on that Son of Man. How do we pray, believers? How do I teach y'all to pray? Face down. I don't teach y'all to pray on your knees. I teach you to pray face down in prostration. What does the book of Enoch say so perfectly about me? And this was here before I was even born. Watch this. Watch this. And all of those who rule the earth will fall down before him on their faces, prostration and worship, and set their hope on that Son of Man. That's what the Quran tells you. Those who believe in Allah and his messenger are those who are rightly guided. How is it possible that this book, the Quran, that this book, the Apocrypha, and that this book, the Bible, are saying the same things if it's not true? Same things that nobody was able to put together before now. But it's in full fulfillment because my life has fulfilled it. My life is fulfilling it and has fulfilled it. Watch this beautiful. Watch how beautiful this is. Now, I'm picking up, and I'm not just picking up these books for show. We're reading them. Isaiah 42. I'm not just picking them up for show. We're reading them. Isaiah 42. Watch this. And they still open. Isaiah 42. See, my servant, you're looking at him. The Most High telling you, look at my servant, the one I uphold, my chosen one. Take a look. You got Isaiah 42 open? Now look at Isaiah 42. Now you're looking at him. That's your visual. He here with you. You here with him. Praise the Most High for making this happen. How's this? Yeah, he chose you to be here. Only people who know who I am were those chosen by God. Look how many people on the line. It's not the Most High won't even, he ain't even putting it out to everybody. He don't want me dealing with all these disbelievers. He want me to talk to those who are rightly guided. Watch this. See my servant who I uphold, my chosen one, who I delight in. Like the Most High talk, the Most High talking big right here. He like, yeah, I delight in him. Don't mess with it. Most High talking big. Yeah, look at my servant, my chosen one. Yeah, that's him. I delight in him. Yeah, I like what he doing. He out here speaking in different languages. He teaching people to be mindful of me, to pray five times a day, to pay alms, tax, and feed the poor. That's my servant right there. My servant. Hey, yeah, my God bragging right here. Let's repeat it. See my servant, who I uphold, my chosen one, and who I delight in. I put my spirit on him. That one right there. And he will reveal justice to the nations of the world. Where the justice at? What the justice he gonna reveal? Bam! The decisive authority. Prophecy fulfilled. It's too late. I done did it now. The decisive authority is here. All nations of the world, you have an invitation to God. You have an invitation to one God. There's only one God. And there's no God worthy of worship except him. Alhamdulillah. Gracias. Dios. Elohio. Dios. Todo poderoso. Hallelujah. Allahu Akbar. Yeah, it's perfection everywhere you go. We back to First Enoch. All right. Nevertheless, the Son, the Lord of spirits, his spirit will press the disbelievers so much that they will go out from his presence and their faces will be filled with shame and darkness will grow deeper on their faces. It's a movie about that out. People getting darkness growing on their faces. This, ooh, that's, man, come on with it. He will deliver them to the angels for punishment and to execute vengeance on them, for they have oppressed his children and his chosen ones. Now, somebody may say, well, it's saying his children here. These are the authors of the book who put children on here. And then, when we get into the heavens, the Most High, we will be called the children of the Most High when we accomplish. And not he ain't, and it still don't mean offspring. It's just because he fathered us. That goes back into the Torah where he fathered us. Fathered us didn't mean he's our father. It means he's fathered as a father would father a child that doesn't have no parent. You know, we supposed to father the fatherless. I see why Trinitarians reject the book of Enoch. Exactly, because it's talking about one God and it's talking about the prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad, me, is the son of man. So, yeah, they don't want you to know. They don't want nobody to know that your covenant is before you. I'm the covenant to the Gentiles, the new covenant. And yes, and this the covenant is a part of this Quran. Before, all prophets went to only the children of Israel. That's why you see Israelites in the streets dressed up in gold and hollering at people and calling them names. And no, man, first of all, y'all can't read the Quran because we ain't supposed, and you can't read the Bible because we ain't supposed to be hollering in the street corners. But they running people off and got and teaching a false doctrine when the final prophet, I'm reaching all nations of the world. We have to speak in other languages. I have to speak in other languages. You see what I'm saying? Like, how can you be talking about, oh, this is only for black people, and now my God don't care about y'all? That's foolishness. Y'all speaking against what I'm teaching, and you're not going to win. Because you can't beat me in a debate, and my God going to smoke you for spreading these lies. Stop telling people that's not colored like you that they ain't going to heaven. I read the Sefer Bible. Sefer costs cheaper, huh? Yeah, a lot of people say that. A lot of people say that. Let's see. Quran says Allah has no children, just slaves. Yeah, you got slaves right now, King Ray. I'm looking at you like you're on a stove or something. Don't you know what slave means, sinner? Y'all say some of the foolish stuff. You look like an oppressor. My people are slaves to your people right now. And slave just means servant. So if you ever went to a place and went out to eat and you never tipped the waiter. You didn't even pay the servant. That was your servant at that time. What you think service means? Let me get into a little teaching. It's some real ignorant people in the world. I'm talking about grossly ignorant too. But that's why the Most High sent this disciple authority down. So let's get into some things. Service definition. Gotta look it up because people don't know what the definition of service is. It's foolish. Yeah, your teachers have failed you, man. All right. To be a servant is to give service. To be a servant is to give service. So there's no such thing as slaves. It's people who work for you to give service. So that's what the Bible talking about. It's not talking about no slaves or people who work. So servants, all right? Act of assistance, favor, kindness, helping hand, all right? So if you're not tipping those waiters, bro, you are doing illegal servitude. And if you got people who work for you and you ain't paying them right and you withholding their wages or you're out here taking money and scamming, you are the one. You are the problem. And you sitting here talking about Allah said he had no children. Just say, I'm a servant of Allah. I serve my God. If you want to call me a slave because of that, because I'm giving favor, helping him, doing what my God wants me to do. I'm doing his service, a duty. Let's get deeper into this. But you'll serve your country. You'll sit there and serve your country and die for your country for nothing. And go to hell and burn in hell anyway. Duty, commitment, obligation, responsibility, obedience. This is why I am called a slave to Allah, sinner, because I have a responsibility. I have an obligation. I am committed to my obligation and I am obedient. So you can take that BS off of here. Nah, you don't get to say nothing else on my live. You done messed up too much. Yeah, you done messed up too much. Nah, they can't come on. You can't see that. We just read that scripture, right? You can't come on my live line. I just corrected them. You ain't going to be on here line. That's go prophecy fulfilled right there. Oh, yeah, he muted. Nah, I already muted him. Yeah, see how they hating on me, though? You got so many people. And this dude following me. What are you following me for? I just gone blocking. How you gonna follow me but hate on me? Get your ass on, man. Yeah, y'all mad. The Most I said y'all was gonna get mad. Let me get back to reciting this Quran. That what y'all mad about. Most I said y'all was gonna be mad. Let me make them matter. Let me make them matter. Alright. Quran chapter 2, verse 130. One God. Look at what my hat say. My hat say, listen, I turn right to the scripture. The verse say one God. Man, my God, beautiful, man. He is so beautiful. He done put me in the scripture before I even came, before I'm fleshly in life. He done put me in all the books. And that's why it ain't working going against me. It's just the dumbest thing to do. All right, chapter 2, verse 130. Adudu Balahi Mini Shaitanir Rajim. Bismillah Rahmanir Rahim. And who would reject the faith of Abraham except the fool? We, the angels of Allah, chose him in this life and in the hereafter. He will surely be among the righteous. When his Lord, Allah, ordered him, submit to my will, he responded, I submit to the Lord of all worlds. This was the advice of Abraham, as well as Jacob, to his children, saying, indeed, Allah has chosen you for this faith of Islam. So do not die except in a state of full submission, which means Islam interpreted in English. Or did you witness when death came to Jacob? He asked his children, who will you worship after my passing? And they replied, we will continue to worship your God, the God of your forefathers, Abraham, Ishmael, and Isaac, the one God, and to him we all submit. That was an Islamic community that had already gone before. For them, they had earned what was for them. And for you, you earn what's for you. And they are not accountable for what you have done. And you are not accountable for what they have done. Wow. Beautiful. Who will reject the faith of Abraham except the fool? So this straight path, full submission of true Islam is the faith of Abraham. So reject that. Reject that. Why do people say Islam didn't exist back then? Because they are the Most High didn't want to reveal it to them. And then when they read the Quran, it says that I'm the first to submit. But they don't understand that I am the first to submit of my generation. It's not saying that I submitted before Abraham. It's saying that I'm the first to submit of this generation because before I came, there was an interval of no prophets. The Most High wasn't sending prophets no more. He was just allowing people to live and not sending no warnings and allowing the children of Israel to work out their servitude. But now the final prophet is here. Then, you know, people want to try to talk about back then all the time. Only thing we need to talk about back then is what the righteous ancestors did and what the wicked did and why our people has got what they got. Yeah, and how we broke the covenant and need to make it right. Yeah, Israelites always want to talk about Ishmael. Well, you following the religion of Ishmael. No, didn't Abraham have Ishmael? Abraham was fully submitted before Ishmael. Y'all just be making up stuff to argue about. That's my brother, man. I ain't hating on him. Y'all better get your knowledge together, man. Quran 16:48. Yeah, I ain't hating on my brother Ishmael. We all who mindful gonna go see our God. And we gonna rejoice. And look at this center right here, clippy clip. Somebody, Christ is God. See, that's so blasphemy. You gonna burn in hell for that, man. You're going to burn in hell for that. You just wronged yourself terribly. Most High, you did it to yourself. I tried to teach you out of it. Ishmael is our brother. Sure is. 16:48. It's called Everything Submits to Allah. Have they not considered how the shadows of everything that Yah Almighty Allah has created, inclined to the right and to the left, as the sun moves, totally submitting to Allah in all humility. What? Man, so it's been revealed that the shadows of objects, it can be a tall building, it can be a huge tree, it can be the shadow of your home. The shadows of the object all recline to the Most High in prostration and submission. Totally submitting, full submission. So when you see the shadow laying down. Submitting to the Most High. When you see your shadow, you look at your shadow laying down. Come on, man. Y'all got to start being mindful. Totally submitting to Allah in all humility. And to Allah alone. Bows in submission, whatever is in the heavens and whatever's on the earth. Man, the sun gonna bow down to God, the clouds, the dragons, the beast, all that, the giant, everything gonna bow down to God. Everything is, it does, as do the angels as well, who are not too proud to do so. They fear their Lord above them and do whatever they are commanded. That is what we're supposed to do, willing servants. We're supposed to fear our God and do whatever he commands. That's what I do. That's what makes my life so easy. That's what I'm gonna do. Man, you are gonna come up and debate me, man, or get on with that bullshit, man. You're an idolater. Calling JC the beginning and the end. Listen, man, y'all just be so lost. Y'all don't read no books. Y'all just blind. So women, if y'all marry a dude like that, it's possibly he gonna spaz out, beat you and spaz out, and probably do something to you. He gonna mislead you. He gonna mess your credit up real bad. That dude will take you down through there. Probably, man. Look at him. Look at his ass. Of the 144, just look at it, bro. Man, that ain't nothing inviting about that picture. That man got he got demonic lit all over his face. And look at what he's saying in the comments to my JC, the Alpha and Omega. So according to your book that you think that you believe in, it say he died, and he died at the hands of men. How you worship somebody that got slayed by men? You guys are baffling, man. You worship a dude that got killed. Really? Like, make that make some sense. But the true story is he didn't die. The true Jesus didn't die. Isa didn't die. He was taken up. And we all gonna see him die. We all gonna die. And we gonna see him resurrected. We all gonna resurrect. And then all y'all that called him God, yeah, he gonna be like, man, I ain't tell y'all to call me that. I don't know that, y'all. I don't know him. He gonna say, I don't know them, y'all. I don't know. They can go. I didn't tell them to say what they said. He gonna say that about y'all disbelieving sinner. From what I read, you were in the beginning and at the end. Oh yeah, that's so yeah, I read that too. I'm gonna be among the righteous, the chosen, the honorable. And when the Most High, before he created the earth, he created me. And he introduced me to Adam. Adam thought I was created before him. Adam asking God, like, oh, who is this? Who is Muhammad? Who's Muhammad? God said, Muhammad is your son. Muhammad is your son. Get away from me, you workers of iniquity. That's what he gonna say. So that's in the New Testament, and it's true. There's what Paul wrote in the New Testament ain't true. But that right there in the New Testament, he's telling the Christians, they gonna say they cast out demons in his name. They prophesied in his name, and they did all these works in his name. He gonna be like, man, I don't know you sending ass people right here. You workers of iniquity. I don't know that. Hell no. Nah, they lying. I ain't telling them to do none of that. I ain't no God. I'm just a messenger like the rest of them. He telling y'all, man, Elijah called fire from heaven. I ain't never called fire from heaven. Elijah did. Y'all call Elijah God? Moses split the Red Sea. Moses drowned Pharaoh in the Red Sea, split the Red Sea, called all kinds of plagues and stuff, and had the firstborn children of Pharaoh killed. I ain't did none of that, Jesus said. Do y'all call Moses God? Come on, man. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Yep, and the Word was willed by God. So when they say the Word was God, it's saying the will of God. It's not saying that I'm God. It's not saying that this is what God willed. This is what God willed, and can't nobody stop it. Can't nobody stop this. And it's, as you can see, it's already happened. We at that point now. I didn't deliver the message. I'm still delivering it, but we in the end. Can't nobody stop that. Yeah, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And all of this is the Word that I'm reciting. All of this. And yes, it's perfection. Watch this. This is beautiful. God's daughters, ? To people who talking about he got children. Verse 57, chapter 16, verse 57. And they attribute angels as daughters to God. Glory be to Allah. The opposite of what they desire for themselves. Ooh, what? He just smoked. Y'all just smoked y'all. Y'all trying to say that the angels are women are daughters. Like, God got daughters. Y'all trying to say the angels are women, feminine. While you people on earth all want sons. Everybody be like, I want a little boy. I want a little boy. You don't hear many people say, I want a little girl. A few of us men do. But you don't hear people say, oh, I want a little girl. You hear them say, I want a little boy. I want a son. Y'all want sons, but y'all want God to have daughters, man. Look how foolish your thoughts are. And they attribute angels as daughters to God, to Allah. Glory be to him. The opposite of what they desire for themselves. Whenever one of them is given the good news of a baby girl, they face growls, gloomy. And he suppresses his rage. He hides himself from people because of the bad news he has received. Should he keep her in disgrace or bury her alive in the ground? Evil indeed is their judgment. To those who disbelieve in the hereafter belong all evil qualities. Whereas to Allah belongs the finest attributes. And he is the Almighty, all wise. Man, yeah, that's so true right there. That's so true right there. My first wife can tell you. One of my baby girls, when she was coming, I had an ex-wife, but she ain't with me no more. She gone, but at the time, she was the second wife, and they was hoping to have a girl, and I was wanting a boy, just like y'all said right here. And they brought the ultrasound, man, and the ultrasound showed it was a girl, and the ex-wife at the time, you know, at the time, she was like, nah, nah, boo, boo, nah, we got it. And she was just trying to rub it in my face, man. Oh, I love my baby now when my baby came, you know what I'm saying? But expecting a boy and having that happen, it was going like that. Yeah, everything that the Quran just said right here, that was happening with me. I was mad. I was trying to hide my rage. I walked away. Yeah, because it's something to be happy about. It's the birth. So, yeah, I'm delighted. And I'm delighted in my baby girls. And praise y'all almighty for them. And it's just something that, see, since we have been created by God, he know all about us. He know the beginning, the end. He know everything. So, yeah, I know I ain't the only one who felt like this or who did something like this. If you got daughters, if you have daughters, some of you might got a lot of boys, but the ones that got daughters, y'all did this. Y'all did it. You have. Allah is perfect. But I grow. I've grown. I've grown, and thank him for the growth and raising me up. Alhamdulillah. All right. Chapter 16, verse 70. God's power over humans. God has created you and then causes you to die. And some of you are left to reach the most feeble stage of life. Everybody don't make it. Some people die early. God brought you in here. He take you out. You go back to him. But some of you reach the most feeble stage of life so that you may know nothing after having known so much. And this is signs for those who are mindful. And Allah is all-knowing, most capable. So, when you start off as a baby and you start learning, you learn so fast, you get smart, you start learning stuff at a rapid rate, you get very wise, and you reach your prime around in your 20s. Then you start hitting your 30s, and you think you're prime, and you start fading. Some people may fade a little later. Some people might fall fading at 40, 50. It's different. But you start fading. You're losing your memory. And you ain't as sharp as you used to be. Yeah, man. That's what the Most High does to show y'all that there's God, man. And can't nobody do that but him. All right. I got 4 girls and 2 boys. So, yeah, I know you hit one when you heard the news. You probably like, damn. Hey, listen. I can't do nothing but keep it real with y'all, tell the truth, because if I don't, I got to stand before God. We all got to stand before him. And he know the truth of everything. So yeah, that's just what it is, man. Y'all got the, you follow y'all not be, you follow the real, you follow the realest, man. All right, so that part where, so the guy talking about where Jesus said your sins are forgiven. Now, the Most High did, so we have to understand that the Most High gave the prophets power to do many things. So it wasn't that he was being the Most High, but when you come to the prophet and ask the prophet to pray for him, and you seek the prophet for the mercy of God, the Most High will forgive your sins. And yeah, that's, so that's in the Quran too. So it says, if you wrong yourself, you have to come to me and ask God for forgiveness, but you have to come repent with me. You have to be like, hey man, pray for me, man, that Allah, you know, make things right. If you don't do that, you're not a true believer. But if you do, Allah gonna forgive you. He gonna forgive you. Yeah. So when Jesus said her sins were forgiven in the New Testament right there, that's not false, man. That's true. And Enoch also, the Most High is saying that Enoch ain't gonna pardon no sins, and he could, you know, you gotta read his book. So people, it's just an understanding. Yah Almighty, Allah is the only one who forgives, who wipes away sin, blots it out and stuff like that. But when Jesus was telling her sins are forgiven, he was saying because of the most compassionate, most merciful. He wasn't saying because like he had the power to do so. No, the Most High just gives the prophets. They can, like, right now, like I'm telling y'all about the adultery thing. If you commit adultery, you should be killed or stoned. But if you think in your mind about sleeping with somebody's wife, you already committed adultery. Now, Jesus said that in his time, but I'm saying that right now. If you don't believe it, then it's just what it is. But it's the truth. Did I change the law? No, I ain't changed the law. It's just the Most High raised my conscience. And I'm sitting here teaching you guys how not to be sinners. If you want to just be a sinner and see how that turned out, then go ahead. But that's why when, you know, there's reasons for women getting on their menstrual cycles. They're supposed to cleanse their body. Their body is cleansing. So you're not supposed to sleep with them while they're on their menstrual cycles. And if you guys are not guided and not reading these scriptures, you would do that. And it's filthy. All right. Thanks for the follow. It'd be good for you to follow my instructions. Yael the Israel says, praise Yah Almighty for the wonderful counselor. All right, so this is prophecy right here that's being fulfilled, right? So we're going to read Quran 3, verse 164. And I just turned right to it, just, and I wasn't on it. That's just how God works. But those who are pagans, they can't read this scripture with understanding. Because they don't understand. They think that their prophet is a dead man. So they not guided right now. The prophet is a blessing and he's not dead. Quran chapter 3 verse 164. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the accursed. Indeed, Allah has done the believers a great favor by raising a messenger from among them, reciting to them his revelations, purifying them, and teaching them the book and wisdom. For indeed, they had previously been clearly astray. That's perfection. That's perfection. God has done the believers a great favor. That is why he said, praise Yah Almighty Allah for the wonderful counselor, Yahudi Yator. I'm the prophet. They have a great favor because I'm reciting to them the things that has been revealed to me. That's what I'm doing, prophecy fulfilled. I have been purifying them. They've been purified by following these words. Because when you do this, you're going to stop the sins that you're doing. And teaching them the book and wisdom. For indeed, before you follow me, you were previously astray. All of this is perfection. All of this is perfection. Look at the scoffers. God called me the son of Ishmael. No, Ishmael, my brother. I'm what you call an Israelite sinner. Russell Wade. Get it together, buddy. If you want to come up and debate, I invite you up. Smoke you real quick. I'll let my wife smoke you in the debate. However you want it, man. It's going to be for good content. Just be respectful. You can have bro as one, the one that's teaching. The counselor is here. That's right, man. Tell him. Y'all not listening. And the one got them beats too, man. Oh, that? Yeah, the one from Jacob, man. The one got, man. Yeah, my boy got some beat stuff, y'all. But don't get a beat. I'm finna, you finna get a me out. I do gotta put you on, though. Yeah, y'all get with him on the beats and stuff, man. Old Prophet does not like when people show up late and speak on the live and just fall in place. There's some people that's working and, some of that come in when they get a chance off their break and they'll speak. They'll be like, peace, salute to the one for counsel. Yeah, they know who they are. Yeah, y'all can salute me whenever, but don't come on the live and say, oh, I was late or I showed up. Nah, see, it's a command in the Quran that you ain't supposed to show up to the meeting late. You got to be on time. No matter what your business is, even if you're working, but the Most High is also compassionate, and I pray for those who believe, and I pray him to forgive y'all sins. So, this is, we on the straight path. There ain't nothing hard and rocky over here, but just don't try to, thank you being sneaky with y'all, because you're not. Yeah, make sure you on the lives, man, when you can be here. Alhamdulillah. Russell Wade said, I'm just running through. Well, don't be running. This ain't a live you run through right here. You can't come through here scoffing. This right here cost you for all eternity. The Most High gonna ask you about what you did up in here. So make sure that you right your wrongs, man. And don't be running around spewing hatred and just saying stuff and try to move along like it don't have consequences. Everything has consequences. So make sure you're accountable for what you do. The Most High is most compassionate and merciful. So yeah, if you ask for forgiveness, maybe he may have mercy upon you. Friday night congregation is a command. Sure is. Yep, this is, so if you're mindful of God, you can't miss it. It's just like missing a prayer. Don't miss a prayer, man. You better miss work before you miss a prayer. Don't miss it. Listen, God is who provide for you. I don't care who you work for, where you work for. You done changed. I bet you done had more than one job in your life. You ain't had more than one God in your life. Yeah, God is the one who provides. So when you trust him, he's going to provide in every way. Yeah, do what he say, and that's all that matters. Before you do what anybody else say, he a jealous God, and that's what that mean. Yeah, if you sitting there obeying somebody else, but you ain't obeying God, he gonna show it up in your life, man. So, if you got a job, you obeying somebody. So make sure you obeying God. Big period. Any questions, man? I trust him more than man for sure. Yeah. Righteous information. Indeed, man. Indeed. That's what we going to add. We ain't finna waste no time about it. Everything we talk about is going to be righteous over here. Everything we talk about is going to be righteous. All right. So, no questions. All right. Let's see. Where's my Dhamma? All right. We're getting the Dhammapada, man. No small book, but it's full of wisdom. We're going to do verse 1. It's one of the verses that you guys should probably put on your wall. You should put where you can see this. You probably should put it in your bathroom on your mirror. Dhammapada 1:1-2. These are the two verses. All that we are is the result of what we have thought. It is founded on what we think. It is made up of our thoughts. If a man speaks or acts with an evil thought, pain follows him. As the wheel of the ox when it draws the carriage. All that we are is the result of what we have thought. It is founded on our thoughts, and it is made up of our thoughts. So if you're a righteous person, why are you righteous? Because you think about God. Why are you a servant of God? Because you think about God. It's made up of your thoughts. Why are you Muhammad? Because I think about God the most. I'm the most considerate of God. It was made up of my thoughts. Why you got on a one God hat? Why you got on a one God shirt? That's what I'm thinking about. Yeah, and it shows. Alhamdulillah. All that we are is the result of what we had thought. It's founded on our thoughts. And it is made up of our thoughts. If a man speaks and acts with a pure, righteous thought, happiness follows him like a shadow that never leaves him. All right. Verse 3. This is a way you should not be. You shouldn't think like this. He abused me. He beat me. He defeated me. He robbed me. He scammed me. Those who harbor such thoughts, will hatred will never cease. All right. So if you keep thinking about that, he scammed me. He got me. No, we only can get ourselves. If you allow somebody to scam you, it's your fault. If you allow somebody to fool you, it is your fault. If you allow somebody to use you, it is your fault. So don't think like that. He abused me. You putting the blame on somebody else. Where is your accountability? He abused me. He beat me. He defeated me. And those who do not harbor such thoughts, hatred will cease. So yeah, somebody scammed you, or somebody used to be your friend and then they lied and turned on you, tried to do some bullshit. He wronged himself. She wronged herself. Don't be around telling people, oh man, he tried to play me. He wronged himself and move on. It is what it is. If you harbor those things, if you keep thinking about what people did to you or what people have done or tried to do to you, then you're going to have hatred in you. And that is not mindful of Allah. All right. Any questions? All right, let's see. Yeah, man, these folks, man, the disbeliever coming up on him, messing with folks and shit, man, y'all be tripping, man. But I know why y'all do it. And the Most High did tell me y'all was gonna do it. The Most High let me know y'all was gonna do it. But that is why he gave me the music too, to make it easy to speak back to you guys when you're not listening. You listen to music, you're gonna get this message one way or the other. You can't stop what y'all Almighty has willed. You cannot break down what can't be broken. Out of all the rankless, I was chosen. When all of the lights, they get low.
And all of the curtains, they close.
You cannot break down what can't be broken. They can do all they can do, but they can't break unbreakable. They scared to face the truth because they hate the view. They taste the juice, I hope it make them puke.
I'm breaking loose.
Should I throw up the deuce or should I wave the deuce? In 1982, my mama take me to a space shuttle. Say, now I'm raising you. It ain't no baby food unless you go and take the neighbor's food. And be afraid of who I made the loot. When money went from army green to navy blue, I said salute. Bulletproof, I gave them proof. Sometimes feel like my head is screwed. Twisting like tornado too, man, I'ma need some crazy glue. A wall is what I'm breaking through. A nail, she gon' break a few. You can never break me down, and I can hit the brakes for you.
You cannot break down.
Face up the accountability. You cannot break down what Yah Almighty has willed. Teaching purposes, you too.
When all of the lights, they get low. And all of the curtains, they close.
They close.
You cannot break down.
You can't. TikTok centers. G-code, G-code. We can't break the G-code. We bros. We bros, we bros. We can't break for these hoes. G-code.
Can't be broken.
And I ain't finna break or fix the brakes. You emulate. I'm laughing in your face. Now fix your face. I can't disintegrate. Cause I facilitate a meal a day for like a million days. At least the bills are paid. The children say, wanna get away? Now I'm here to stay. I'm really great. Don't discriminate. Cause I done seen a mirror break behind a pretty face. You sticking out your chest.
Your titties fake. Don't make me pick your face.
I'm picking out a mate. She get replaced. The heart was built to break. I'm smoking icky. Watching Ricky Lake. I got a lawyer that turned any case into a pillowcase. My killer straight. Do some Q&A. You saw the news that they got news to break. The tune to break is worth the wait. Commercial break. Talk to them. You cannot break down what can be broken. Out of all the rankless, I was chosen. When all of the lights they get low and all of the curtains they close, the day of accountability is near. TikTok centers.
G-code.
We can't break the G-code. We bros. We bros. We bros. We can't break for these hoes. G-code.
Can't be broken.
Can't be broken, man. We cannot break for these disbelievers, pagans, and sinners, man. Nah, can't be broken. Praise the Almighty Allah. God, Dios. Whatever beautiful name you call him, just don't call him a man's name or associate him with worship. All right. The clear proof. The verification of the scriptures. Yes, God is real. And you can see why. Yes, I love your physical, but it's your energy. I have no fear to put you on a pedestal, but are you trusting me? I feel like I picked the right time to hit your line. Now you all mine. Been anticipated for a long time, but you verify how I feel inside. Wow. You got berry eyes. For y'all to speak to us through the music, man, and that's another level of love, man. And I'm talking about beautiful, like whatever genre you want to listen to. Slow, faster, you want to ride, like y'all got it for us. I got vibes all on my line. She just won't be verified. The difference is I think one of a kind. Come on. Yes, I love your physical, but it's your energy. I had no fear to put you on a pedestal, but are you trusting me? I feel like I picked the right time to hit your line. Now you all mine. That's how I hit my wife, y'all. That's how I hit my second wife. I had to pick the right time to hit her line, and she became mine. I was already watching her. And you know what I'm saying? And it's like when I was watching, it's like y'all put a familiarity to me on me to her. And we didn't even know each other. I'm just looking at it on TikTok. But it's like the familiarity he was just showing me that she was my wife and she was gonna be my wife. So man, like when we first exchanged words, man. I was talking to her like we already. I'm like, man, I say, listen. He's like, I say, I got the hammer. You got the nail, I got the hammer. Let's get together and build. And man, she was like, let's do it. I'm talking about, man, we got married in 7 days. I met my wife and married her in 7 days. And look, we here now rocking and doing this beautiful stuff. Yeah, man. Doing it very beautiful. And my wife is recruiting some good help, you know, for the prophet and his family and for, you know, business purposes and things like that. So if it's some good help out there who's very considerate, family oriented, and willing to learn about your God. Come on, man. Hit the inbox. You can DM me or DM the wife, Mrs. Muhammad. And let's talk business. Let's deal. We got the hammer, the nail. We got all that. So we just need consideration, willingness, and obedience. All right? The right time to hit your line. It got to be the right time. And that's what TikTok is about. TikTok. All right. Oh yeah, it's very beautiful. It was hard. I told her, I was like, man, it's like I already knew you was gonna be my wife. It was just a feeling, you know. And what really set it in though, when I started teaching her about y'all, she just wanted to know more. Man, I was on the phone with her the first time, like 4 hours. We talked like five. We talked about 5 hours the first day. But I was talking about God the whole time. I wasn't sitting there talking about, oh, I do this and I do that. I was just like, no, God do this, and he did this, and he said this, and he said that. And she was just, the fact that she wanted to know more, that turned me on. The fact she wanted to know more, and she was listening, and then I was telling her some deep stuff about God. Like, sometimes, man, I be talking to women, and I tell them something about God. They ass won't write back. They won't text back. So, shit, I ain't gonna text back. I know it's my knowledge may be too much for you, or you might want to stay in sin or something. I'm not, you know, and that's just what it is. It happens, you know. But nah, with her, the more I talked about God, the more she wanted to know. So shit, I was talking all the time, and in fact, she wanted to hear me all the time. Shit, it was time to make it happen. Y'all do have a beautiful story, yeah, man. It's just talking about it and being able to, because people hate and scoff us all the time, man. And what y'all don't see is y'all don't see the praying. Y'all don't see the adversity. Y'all don't see, you know, what the Most High bless. Y'all see my light. Y'all see me, you know, happy, and you know, that's a good thing to see. But yeah, man, you gotta put in that work praying. You gotta give. You gotta be a giver. You don't see those things. I ain't gonna be on here showing y'all, you know, my Cash Apps, and you know, the Most I see that, I'm doing it for him. The Most I see me, I'm a tipper. I'm a tipper. I don't want none of my followers not to be tippers. If you believe in me, you believe in God, you believe in his prophets, you believe in me. If you're going out somewhere to eat, if you're around here getting to service somebody, make sure you tip them. Unless you ain't got it, I understand that. But we tippers, man. Give. We givers. And however you look at it. You walk off somebody without tipping them, God gonna be mad at your ass. And I done told you what it is. So we ain't doing that. That ain't how true believers rock. I'm still like that today. Keep teaching me about God. I continue to submit to you. That's what I'm talking about. That's what makes women submit, is the teaching, is the guidance. You was a little feisty something at first, though, but yeah. The fact that, you know, to be able to, you know, lead one that I knew was astray, and, you know, and she's happy to be led, that's a beautiful thing. He definitely a tip. Oh yeah, I got it, you're gonna know. You know, your day gonna, you know, just make sure, you know, just have it. Y'all gonna know God come through. Y'all gonna know God sent the prophet. Yes, that's when if you meet me personally, if you meet, you're gonna know God sent the prophet. That's just what it is. I ain't gonna be telling nobody I'm a prophet in person and stuff like that unless it's just revealed to you. I don't do none of that. But if you can't see it, it just ain't for you to see. But yeah. I would love to be around y'all praying. Yeah, we supposed to get together as believers. We supposed to pray together. When that time comes, we're gonna work towards it. That's what the alms tax fund is for. So, you know, and I'm not just saying like if you pay $21 a week, you good. The Most High know how much y'all make, man. If you sitting there making $1,000 a week, $2,000 a week, and that's all you doing is $20 or $20, that's still good, but you can do more. The Most High is the one provides. So come on, man. Come on with it. We're going to make this thing move around fast. We're going to get land, and we're going to get stuff for our people, man, for those who believe, so we can live amongst one another. But it got to start from somewhere, and it got to start from y'all obedience. Those who say, they're believers, it's going to show. And a few, you know, like I said, I don't know what y'all doing home, but a few have been consistent with the alms tax. They've been consistent. And I make sure that my family pay ours. I make sure we paying ours. Yeah, you back for more. Yeah, you got slayed. Why you keep coming back? Don't nobody invited you here. I apologize for being feisty and trying you when I shouldn't have. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I understand, you know, you understand a lot better now. And that's what, see, the Most High never told the prophets that they, you know, they women wouldn't. You know, just, but see, now it just shows me what more to deal with and what not to deal with. Like, I can't even, I'm not even going to date a woman who just don't listen. So, you know, as before, you know, I would just be patient. You know, I have patience and, but it, you know, if a woman just ain't listening at all, they don't want to learn about God, you don't want to learn about me. You can't learn about me, but don't learn about God. That don't work. It's just not going to work. Cause God, without God, I ain't nothing. There's no me without God. Without Allah, there is no Muhammad. There is no Yahudi, Yator, Buddha, none of that. Okay, question. What is your religion? True Islam. The straight path. All right, the only true religion that stands above all other religions. All right, alhamdulillah. Yeah, one thing about it, I ain't got no more fighting for doing no rebellion and shit. Your ass don't want to listen, you just ain't gonna be around. Ain't nothing but blessing. Now, me being the prophet of God, ain't no woman gonna come in to my, they want a dowry. Y'all shouldn't come in to, okay, we want you to pay a dowry. Now, I do, because that's what God brought onto me. But man, you know what I'm saying? You're gonna have to be like getting it, making it happen to get that dowry from the counselor, because when you come in, you know, if you come in and you're doing what you're supposed to do, the Most High gonna bestow his blessings on us, period. Like, and then my family is just gonna be a total blessing to you. So unless, you know, now if you working immediately and you traveling from across the country and you immediately starting right now, shit, what, how much you want? Shit, we'll put the dowry down. But yeah, if you know, we gonna, You'll be safe, secure, and growing with the prophet. But, you know, don't be, some people going, oh, we supposed to pay dowry? I need $5,000. And you ain't proved nothing. Or you don't even believe, or you don't even know how to read a few scriptures, man. No. Just be realistic. We got to be realistic, man. All right? Same to you guys who believe. You know, you see a nice piece, a nice thing, you know, something that you want to try to, they know you're supposed to pay your dowry. Yeah, make your dowry solid, but let them know, look, you got to learn about God. You have to learn about God, man. You're going to have to follow my lead and follow this prophet right here. Mm-hmm. Any questions, people? We at the end. We at the checkout now. We at checkout. I don't want to leave nobody unedified. I don't want to hit nobody unedified, because I'm the one who verify. I'm the verification. So come on with it.
It on me, my position locked down. My position locked down. Fixing all my friendship before me. But you know me, won't set you up for letdown. Won't set you up for letdown.
I'm participating in whatever it is. That's what I want to hear. And whatever it is, the charges that you're in, I throw the tile all in for you. But it's your energy.
I don't feel I put you on a pedestal.
But are you trusting me?
I feel like I picked the right time to hit your line. You are mine.
You are mine.
Hey. Yeah, but
feel inside.
Well, I feel you.
Yes,
I verify what the Most High feel inside, man. Verify what the Most High feels inside. All right. And he's the comforter. And he said he a sinner comforter. That's what he sent me as. Alright. And Yah will be your comforter. I will make it right. Praise Yah Almighty, Allah, the Lord of all worlds, the most compassionate, the most merciful, master of a day of judgment. You alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Guide us along the straight path, the path of those that you have blessed, not the path of those you're displeased with, or those who are astray. See, he's heard you again when you're in pain. That's part of being a friend. I have my feelings back because of him, and now I can see it more than ever. A big, big, big mistake. I would never disregard your feelings, but I think that he's a fool. He don't know how sensitive you are, and baby, that just ain't cool. I'm just glad I can be here for you when you need a helping hand. And deep inside my heart from the start, I know I should have been your man. Whoa. And tell me what's on your mind. What exactly did he do
to make you cry this time?
Allah will be your comforter. I will. Well, and I'ma bring back your life. Teaching purposes, you two don't take this down. I know it flowed for a minute. I do not own the rights to this music. It's very educational. And our God is speaking through the music. He's gonna bring back your light, and your light is here, the beacon of light. And he has the light in his hands. Learn from the light as we proceed and persevere through life challenges. All right? We're going to read Quran chapter 44, verse 51. And it's called Pleasures of Paradise. Indeed, the righteous will be in a secure place amid gardens and springs dressed in fine silk and a rich brassard, facing one another. So it will be, and we will pair them with maidens with gorgeous eyes, and there they will call for every fruit in serenity. There they will never taste death beyond the first death, and he will protect them from the punishment of hellfire as an act from grace from your Lord, and that is truly the ultimate triumph.
praise Ya Almighty Allah forever, the comforter. What exactly did he do
to make you cry
this time? Allah will be a comforter, and I will make it right. He cast the shadow on your heart. Praise Yah Almighty Allah forever for his monumental revelations. All right. Thank you, Almighty, for bringing the believers on here, for those who came by to listen, learn. We also thank him for the scoffers as evidence and a test so that we can know who are truly rightly guided and the perfection of his words. We thank him for the angels. We thank him for our righteous ancestors. We thank him for these monumental books. We thank him for grace. I ask you to forgive us, the believers, and our family of any sin or any wrongdoing, knowing or unknowingly. We ask you to protect us from the evil of whatever you have created, Yah, seen or unseen. We ask you to continue to increase our knowledge and wisdom as we desire your words. We desire your knowledge. We desire your revelations. And we will look forward to seeing them for all eternity. Thank you for keeping us rightly guided and giving us the religion of truth that prevails over all other religions. There is no God worthy of worship except you, the one true God, Maliki Al-Medin, the master of the day of judgment. And we look forward to seeing you in the hereafter. To you we come from, to you we return. May we die and pass away as true believers fully submitted to you, or may we live until the day of judgment as true believers fully submitted to you. Only you know. We look forward to what you have for us. As for now, give us strength to persevere. Give us strength to be mindful in the times of unmindfulness. Give our wives and give our children peaceful minds of serenity and thoughts about you and servicing you. Thank you, Yah Almighty Allah, for hearing our prayers and being so gracious and merciful to us. There's no one who compares to your grace and your mercy. And we truly, fully submitted to you. Thank you for hearing the prayers of your prophet Muhammad. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Elohio Dios Todo Poderoso. Praise Yah Almighty Allah, the perpetual God, forever. All right. Peace. We're going to be back on here another time sometime next week. If not on Friday, we're going to be Friday, inshallah. If y'all, unless Allah changes something, inshallah, we'll be back Friday, but may go live another time before then, because said we're gonna do some more lives, we're gonna be some more content. That's what it is. So just stay tuned, man. Stay mindful of your God. Pay your alms tax, feed the poor, and repent when you do something wrong. Alright? True guidance from the messenger among your brother. Peace.